Alright, we are recording. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again to an episode of Shadowrun Actual Play. This is episode 2 of the actual play, and for those of you who watched episode 1, you may notice we have a few new players this week. So, it's kind of awesome. We've got a kind of a full game going on, so this will be fun. So, alright, since we have some new players, we will have everybody introduce yourselves, but first, we're going to go ahead and get you to the meeting. Dan, you are not with them yet. The rest of you, Bull has given you guys a call, Bull the Orc Decker. Some of you guys have him as contact, some of you do not. That is perfectly fine. Again, you all know who Bull is. And Bull has given you guys a call, and he has said, I have a job lined up for you. If you're interested in meeting Mr. Johnson, meet me at the gold mine at 9 o'clock tonight. The gold mine is a bar slash club slash strip club that Bull is the owner of in the Orc Underground. So off to the Orc Underground you all head. There are two main entrances to the Orc Underground, the public area of the Orc Underground. There is the Lordstrom's department store, which the store itself is not 24 hours, but in the lobby area, there's a set of stairs going down into the entrance, and that section is A, highly guarded, but B, open to the public 24 hours. There is also an entrance at the Big Rhino, an orcish eating establishment, and that is not quite a 24-hour entrance, because they're only open when the restaurant's open. How would you guys like to go down into the Orc Underground?
I'm going to go in through Lordstrom's.
Highly guarded by Knight Errant.
I'm sorry, on both ends, or just on the Lordstrom side?
Mainly on the Lordstrom side, because that's the only one that's completely open to the public. The Big Rhino one, you actually have to go into the restaurant itself. Although this is downtown, so Knight Errant's, you know, spitting distance away at any given point.
I think Tooth is probably a Big Rhino guy.
Yeah, Mikey's going to go from the Big, just eat dinner at the Big Rhino, linger for a bit, and then head downstairs instead of up top when he's done with his meal.
All right. Are you going to actually get the, are you going to just go for something good and big and spicy, or are you going to go for authentic orc? You know?
A little bit of both.
Okay.
He's a big guy. He'll probably get one of each.
All right. So you get a big plate of big slab of ribs and some fried earthworms. It's tasty.
Sounds good. Little sriracha on those worms. They're just fine.
There you go.
Lordstrom's here, parking near wherever the ice cream truck's husk is.
Oh, the husk is long gone. You guys left the husk of the ice cream truck, and as I recall, that was down near Pyalup.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, unless you really wanted to tow it back, but there really wasn't much point.
I don't think I want that rap sheet on me.
Yeah. Well, you know.
It's not a mental attachment.
We'll get another one. We'll blow one up every session.
All right.
Life goals.
All right. So Tooth and Mikey's going there. Ness and Dash. Are you guys heading over to the Rhino or the Lordstrom's?
I'll head over to the Rhino. All
right.
I was going Lordstrom's because I don't think an elf would fit in very well at the Big Rhino.
Okay. So we got two elves, two trolls, and a human that looks like an orc.
And, looks like a good orc or looks like a bad orc?
He's a pretty good orc. In fact, most of you guys probably aren't aware that he isn't an orc. He actually took ranks in impersonate with specialization orc. So,
yeah. Looks like an orc.
I like it.
He looks like an orc. He kind of smells like an orc, even.
I've seen that at gaming cons. That's not any kind of.
Okay. This will be fun. All right. The Big Rhino's fairly busy. It's a Friday night, so it's pretty packed, but you guys managed to get seats okay. It doesn't take too terribly long. The food is delicious, assuming you're into that sort of thing. Fortunately, they do, despite having orc sizes and being orcish cuisine, they do actually cater to non-orc underground tastes. So there's plenty of food that does not come with rat or cockroach or worms or whatever else passes for authentic orc underground cuisine these days. Lots of ribs, steaks, you know. It's pretty much hell if you're a vegetarian or vegan, though. So hopefully nobody that went there is.
Tooth's not eating there, if that's a problem. He ate at his mom's house beforehand.
Oh, okay. No, that's no problem.
Sure. Yeah, you know, like you do.
Well, you can also get a drink there.
That works.
Do you want the Hurlg?
No, I do not want the Hurlg.
Now, Chris, it's not so bad. He's actually a troll. He could probably actually take it.
It's like Goth, but better.
All right.
He could, but he's lactose intolerant.
If you guys
want to
eat,
you go.
All right. If you guys want to eat, that's cool. If not, that's cool. And then you guys head down. The gold mine is actually kind of towards that end of the Orc Underground anyways. All right. If you look on the map, the purple, I think I kind of showed you guys this before, but the purple line is the tourist highway area of the Orc Underground. That's the open to the public area that everybody's familiar with, and it's pretty much just lined with food stalls and gift shops and peddlers and grifters and whatever.
The arcology again.
Yes. So anyways, yeah, and like I said, it extends much further than that, but this is like the open area that anybody can get to without any too many problems. Wander on past that if you're not, an orc or possibly a troll or a dwarf. Or a human poser that people don't recognize.
You may
look a little funny. Anyways, the big rhino's down at the knife and fork. The Lordstrom's is up at the little television and New Yen symbol. And the gold mine is kind of right where there's kind of like a little blue icon. I don't know what that's supposed to be. It's underneath the purple. That's more or less right around where the big rhino is.
So the bus cool. stop.
Yeah, is that a bus stop? Okay. Either way, it's right around there where that road crosses. So it's not too far from your end. The two elves went up to Lordstrom's. You guys head down. You guys head down that way. And like I said, there's a fair amount of security down here. Kind of what knight errant looks like these days.
Tron Sheik.
Yes.
Okay. I can dig it.
All right. You guys, but it's not too big a problem. Like I said, it's an open entrance, and they're mainly there to kind of keep an eye on things and to make sure that nobody causes problems, because they've had any number of problems in the past. You guys head down and are making your way through the crowds. And the Orc Underground, like I said, it's a fairly... it's a fairly crowded place. Tourist highway, a lot of orcs, of course. Plenty of metahumans in general. Elves are a little rare. Humans are pretty common down here. But you do tend to notice that the non-orcs and trolls tend to get looks from the orcs and trolls. They kind of watch you, a little bit wary. So you guys are walking through and... yeah, you're getting a few looks. Up top, you know, you'll get stopped by the cops for walking while troll. Down here, you'll get stopped by the locals for walking while elf. See, and the dogs agree.
Dogs also bark at you.
Yes.
Sorry, we got a storm rolling in, and it freaks out my mutts.
Oh, that's all right. So you're walking through, and as you're kind of walking past one of the, there's a kind of a restaurant that's actually a, it's a noodle place, sort of serves ramen and other types of noodly type foods, and they're actually a, it looks like somebody cut the front end of a bus off, and mounted it on the wall, and so the kitchen's behind that, and they kind of serve onto the hood of the bus. And there's a few little stools sitting out front. As you guys are walking past there, though, there's two orcs that are sitting at the bar, or sitting at the little stools. They get up and walk right in front of you. They kind of almost bump right into you. The dogs agree. They kind of give you a look as they do. Both the orcs are fairly good sized, burly. They look like street orcs. Leather jackets, you know, torn up jeans, kind of rough looking, probably armed. As one of the orcs turns around, you notice the back of his jacket has a, it looks like a gang sign. There's something written on it that that I'm assuming you don't understand, because I don't think either of you read or is it.
I have a rank one in it, to know the swear words.
Okay. There's no swear words. There's no swear words, and you recognize swear words and a few common words, but you really can't read it at rank one. It's more of a, you're more of lingually, you know it, verbally. So, they have something written on the back of the jackets, and there's an icon of, it looks like a, an old school, kind of knobby looking cyber hand in a circle. They turn around and they gutturally shout something at you, because Orzett's a lot like Klingon or German. It's a very shouty language. He mutters something at you. Dash, you kind of pick up son of a bitch, something something shoes.
Dandelion.
That
was what you picked up.
All right.
Because he's not swearing at you at the moment, apparently, other than son of a bitch.
All right, you want me to make an Orzett check?
Yes, make an Orzett check. So it's one plus your logic. I almost said intelligence.
I got three hits.
All right. Okay, you actually pick him up. You actually pick up a good bit of it, actually, then. He actually says, he basically says something about, what are you doing down here? This isn't your turf, you son of a bitch. You bumped into me, now you're going to have to pay the toll, or I'm going to make you eat your shoes.
All right, I will apologize and explain that I'm just here to meet someone at the gold mine. I have a meeting with Bull McAllister at the gold mine.
All right. Are you trying to explain this to him in Orzett?
No, I'm going to go with just straight up regular English. I don't want to insult him by mangling his language any more than I already can.
As soon as I hear him talking about Bull, I'm going to stop and pay attention just to, you know, stand by him.
What, you weren't paying attention before?
Not really. There are orcs.
Oh. Woof. Racism.
And the casual racism continues.
I took a step away from Chris.
Meta-human racism Monday. All right.
Would you like me to make an etiquette roll as I explain this?
No, that's all right. He starts muttering something to you, and you can't tell if he's like debating. It looks like he's debating with himself as to whether to mess with you or not. But as he is, this orc, you want to say kid, you know how when a puppy is starting to grow and it's got like the really big hands and the really big head, but the body's still really small? This orc kid comes running up to you, and you guess he's maybe around 16 or 17 years old, but he kind of looks like that. Big hands, big feet, kind of a slightly oversized head, but still kind of really gangly looking. And he runs up and he starts saying something in Orzett to these two guys. And they kind of shrug and they turn back to the noodles. You kind of pick up bits and pieces of it, Dash, and he's basically telling them he'll take care of it. He'll make sure they get where they go, and they're that he won't let the weed eaters do any cause any problems. And they kind of just shrug and turn away. And he looks at you two, and he goes, you and Chris, he goes, You guys, you almost caused yourself some problems there. You don't want to mess with the Sons of Cam. They're not nice people. He says, listen, I heard you say something about Bull, right?
That's right.
You guys are Shadowrunners, aren't you? I can tell. You look like Shadowrunners. Listen, my name's Pip. I'm a guide around here. He says, why don't I take you where you're going so you don't run into any more trouble, huh?
Sounds great.
All right. Come on. All right. So he leads you through the crowds. You don't have any other problems. He gets you to the gold mine. And when he gets you there, he turns around and he goes, that'll be 50 new yen.
I give him 100.
He looks at you and goes, wow. Awesome. He says, what's your guys' names?
I'm not saying and you're not asking.
I was asking, but well, whatever. Jesus. He looks at you, Dash.
Dash.
Ah. Well, I told you I'm Pip. He kind of pulls up his conlink and he presses a button and a digital business card for all intents and purposes gets delivered over to your a little pop-up pops up and do you want to accept?
I accept it.
Okay.
That's and I'll accept it too.
He didn't send it to you.
Oh, okay. I just gave him 100% tip and he's not doing anything.
Yes, but then
okay.
You didn't want to talk to him.
I...
You're going to be a dick. He goes, you guys call me if you need me, if you ever need any help down here.
I will. Thank you.
I deserve that.
He's an awful.
All right. He's like, Tubble, I said, hey, and he runs off. About this time, the guys that were over at the Big Rhino are kind of walking up as well. So you guys all see each other kind of standing outside the gold mine. The entrance to the gold mine looks a lot like looks like kind of like an old like a 1849 mine shaft entrance. Kind of got the boards and the wood, and there's like a wagon wheel out front and. It's a whole thing. They're kind of rolling with the decorations, but up in like sparkly lights above the entrance. It says the gold mine. I'm assuming you guys are heading in.
Yeah, Tooth. I mean, he's got Maxine as a contact, so I assume he gets straight to the bar and.
Not a problem. You've been there any number of times. Like I said, you guys have all been there at least once to meet before, more than likely. So.
Yeah.
Walking, but I'm giving you guys the description because as players, you've never been here, except for Chris. There's a short hallway, maybe about 20 feet long, that goes in. And the hallway, again, kind of has that whole mineshaft look to it. There's like some pickaxes and stuff in little display cases along the wall, and some old lanterns, and a couple of dead canaries. And then you get to the end of the hall, and then it opens up into a large club. And again, this is a fairly modern looking place. There's a couple of stripper poles off on one side, and one area there's a couple of female dancers. One area there's a couple of male dancers. There's kind of a dance club off in another section in the middle, and then there's a bar area along one wall. Tooth and anybody else who might have her, Maxine is working the bar.
That's what I make a beeline for that.
Okay. I will go over and say hello as well.
Okay.
She has a name, too.
Maxine.
I was making a joke about the that, but...
All right. You guys head over and visit with Maxine for a moment. She's busy pouring a couple of drinks. There's her and there's another orc behind the bar, a male, who's also pouring drinks and stuff. You walk up and she looks up and she goes, hey! How's it going, guys? What can I get for you tonight?
The usual.
The usual. All right. She goes and she pulls you a, the usual. You're not entirely sure what the usual is, but...
I get it every time, though.
You're pretty sure it's beer with a shot of vodka and a little bit of Tabasco sauce and maybe some bar rag squeezings.
Perfect.
All right.
Half a cup of milk.
Oh, what?
Lactose intolerant. We've already established that.
You really haymaker prairie?
And a slice of cheese.
Russian?
Oh, no. Really, it's going to hurt the rest
of you. We're starting with
the... I step away from Tooth a little bit at this point.
All right. She goes, so you got the whole crew here tonight, it looks like. You guys here for business or pleasure? She looks over business. At Chris and goes, you know, Jim's been asking about you. He's off tonight, though, so I'll let him know he missed you. He's going to be disappointed.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe this business won't be as pleasurable as last time, so we'll see.
Oh, okay.
So, does Tooth know who Jim is?
Yeah, I'm curious as well, too.
Yeah,
raise an eyebrow.
Well, you guys have Maxine as a contact, right?
Yeah.
That's right.
All right, you guys are regular here enough. You know that Jim is one of the strippers.
All right.
Not judging.
Also, he also does waitering sometimes as well.
Waitering, sure.
An occasional help with unconscious bodies.
Again, not judging.
Sounds like a happy guy.
She looks over at Chris and it's like, do you want the regular? The usual?
No, not at this time.
All right. That's probably a good thing. We don't want to carry you out again.
I will build up a tolerance, but not tonight.
Got to get your bread base down first.
All right, you guys don't see Bull anywhere out in the... because sometimes he sets up at a table, sometimes he's in one of the back rooms. You don't see him.
I was going to ask, is that unusual for him to not be out here?
It all depends on the nature of the meeting.
Okay.
So, like I said, you know he's used... There's a back room that's specifically set up for meetings, for a meeting room. So he's probably back there, but...
Okay.
Maxine would not.
I have to ask as well. Is Maxine a huge Sylvester Stallone fan? Has she been watching Cobra over and over and over again? And that's why she has the matchstick? Is that what that's about?
I don't know.
Okay, fair enough. It's a mystery. So, yeah, Tooth will ask, is he ready for us, or does he need us to hang out here?
Oh, yeah, you're here to meet with Bull, huh?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Go on back. You know where it's at, right?
Yeah.
All right.
I assume I do.
You do.
I don't think I'll fake it. Fake it till I make it.
There's a hallway around the corner. You go down there, and this is where there's a couple of rooms that are like private rooms for private dances. But the third room has been converted over to meeting room.
So did the six of us or the five of us arrive at relatively the same time? Is that what I'm picking up?
Yes, yeah. You guys all kind of met up outside the club. Guys just happened to all arrive more or less at the same time.
All right.
You guys go around the back, or go around down the hallway. Like I said, there's two rooms. One of the doors is closed, one of the doors is open, and it is occupied. Apparently they don't mind a little public viewing.
Yeah. Plus, that way security can keep an eye on things.
And then, they didn't pay enough for the private room.
Yeah.
But then you get down to the end of the last door, and the door is closed. But you know, this is the meeting room.
I'll knock at the door.
All right. Come in.
Tooth kind of gives Dash that look like, you want me to go through the door first?
I'll open the door and gesture for him to go ahead.
To be fair,
I'll step in.
You are the troll.
Exactly. We have this established. Step in, make sure in case there's gunfire suddenly, as happens.
All right, you step through the door, and you see this is, like I said, it is a meeting room. This room has there's a long table with maybe about 9-10 seats around it. A couple of them, there's three that are kind of oversized, look like they're designed for trolls. The rest are kind of normal sized. There's a couple booster seats sitting in the corner, probably for the dwarves. I'm sure they love that. But you see seated at the head of the table, a certain orc, Decker. Seated next to him is a slightly older gentleman, graying hair, grayish, gray-black goatee, wearing a very, very dapper-looking, very nice suit, and an overcoat. And he is sitting next to Bull. Bull gestures for you guys and says, come on in, guys.
They're the only two people in the room?
They are the only two people in the room.
Okay. Tooth will go take a seat then.
I will miss the Gouster. And...
Oh, I'm sorry. They are not the only two people in the room. I apologize. You also see sitting in the room... You also see sitting in the room this gentleman. Okay. Chris, you recognize him. It's Will Smith.
Huh. All right.
That's what Will Smith actually looks like.
Yay!
As opposed to the Fresh Prince.
Of course.
or the guy who does the tech TV.
Exactly.
Nice.
You see him sitting there.
I'm very familiar with him.
Looking slightly, probably a little nervous.
I salute him, say, good to see you on your feet.
Well, as much on my feet as I can be, yeah.
Yeah, Tooth does not see anything alarming to keep him from taking a seat.
Okay.
In these three.
Yeah, you don't see none of them appear to be armed, or at least openly armed. Sorry, what were you saying, Russ?
Mikey will probably be the last one in the room. Okay. Since one troll will take point, the other one will have drifted to the back of the pack. So he's watching a group six, like when we're stopped at the door. He's in the back, just casual about it. Everything he does seems to be kind of relaxed, but he just happens to like turn away from the door and be watching the group six when the other one's knocking at the door. And, you know, so he'll amble in last, that sort of thing. But yeah, he'll join in and take a seat at one of the troll chairs.
Two new lists. Tack.
A lot of people don't know this, but trolls are natural herd animals.
So, depending on your feelings here, you guys either feel really secure knowing that there's a troll on either side of you, or really, really nervous.
Yeah.
One of the two.
Maybe both.
Heard about video footage, something like a troll sandwich.
You may have been kidnapped. Sorry.
Like I said, Bull motions for you to take a seat. Once you've taken a seat, Bull says, gentlemen, I'm glad you all can make it. Real quick, I'd like to take a moment, and I'd like to have you guys each describe your characters to each other, since for some of you this is your first time out of game meeting each other, at least. So, Chris, why don't we start with you and just go across the board here.
All right. So I'm dressed basically in a somewhat upscale armored, pretty obvious suit. Wide-brimmed hat, looks kind of like what you would expect a lawyer or judge in the Old West to look like, and right down to the... you said there was a lot of security coming in, so the weapon should be holstered and hidden, right?
Yeah. So you're not openly carrying anything huge, you're probably all right.
Yeah, I'm not carrying my sword with me at the moment.
Plus the security's probably slightly more concerned with people bringing weapons out of the Orc Underground than in.
True. So... Yeah, picture basically like that wide-brimmed judge/lawyer look from the Old West.
Good.
You need to find a picture for your character.
I really do. I need to commission one. Or look at Doomtown. You know.
Yeah, I was going to say, you could probably find one if you just look at a little Deadlands art.
Yeah.
And Chris is one of the elves, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, just keeping track.
Dash.
All right. I assume you all can see the picture, the avatar picture. I can't see it, so I don't know what's actually there.
It's a little dark.
He's got short, blondish brown hair, light brown hair. He's an elf. He is wearing a shirt and tie, a nice red tie to cover bloodstains.
Sure.
And he's dressed pretty formally. He's carrying two pistols, but they're not obviously, they're concealed. Somewhat, as best one can. And he's a face man. So he has the, the social graces that far better than my personal one, so.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yes, yes it is. It'd be a very bad face man if it was just me. But anyway, so that's kind of what he looks like. I should point out, he doesn't really have any obvious cyberware.
Tooth is a troll of Puerto Rican descent, so he's got kind of a light brown skin tone. He is dressed much more casually than the elves, typical jeans and combat boots. He wears a armored jacket over a vest, no shirt. covered in tattoos that you can see, mostly of a tribal nature. Here's a question. He normally carries a sawed-off Defiance T250 on his hip, but if that's frowned upon, he would have checked it or left it behind, whatever.
Yeah, you're probably not carrying that. You probably want to stick with hand. You probably want to stick with handguns. If you've got
that
one.
That is his handgun. It's sawed off. I mentioned that.
Oh well.
He was very clear.
Actually, yeah. If it's sawed off, then yeah, you could tuck that in your jacket. You're big enough.
He could, but he doesn't. He puts it in a holster. So if that's frowned upon, he leaves it behind. Right. He has no problem with that. And then he does have knives secreted about his person.
Well, it is as long as you've got a firearms license, it is legal to carry one.
Oh no, he doesn't have that. No.
Oh, okay.
No, that's not a thing.
Just checking. I uploaded the picture that that Tony sent me for Dash, so that's what's on the screen there.
So he also does not have any obvious cyberware, but moves pretty gracefully. He does have a high charisma for a troll at a 3, so he tries to, from working with him in the past, you would know, he tries to be polite. He's a cordial individual. His mama taught him right.
All right. Ness.
All right. Ness is kind of a little bit on the scrawny side of for an orc. He at least appears to be an orc. He's got the tusks and everything. He's wearing a lined coat. No obvious weapons on him, but you do see two data jacks coming out of the back of his head and the cords running down the back of his jacket.
Old school.
Yeah. Unless Ness has said otherwise, everybody would assume he is an orc.
Do we know him well enough to know otherwise or no?
No, he wouldn't have shared that. Not yet.
Okay. So.
Fair enough.
And then Rusty.
Mikey Behrens is a known and very clearly like a former company man archetype. He's got a nice synergist business suit on. With that flowing long coat over it, and he fills it out. He's got pretty solid body score even for a troll. He blends in really creepy ways though. He's been taught how to move, especially through like a crowd in the underground, just kind of moving slowly, hunching down a little bit, and blending in really kind of creepily easy way, in that he's got both a very high sneaking score and blandness. He's had some work done, some dental touch-ups and probably some other minor cosmetic stuff under his time as like a corporate bodyguard. He's got like silver caps on his troll horns. It's just a little kind of turning them into jewelry, sort of touch of class type of thing. No weapons obvious and out, but you guys are all Shadowrunners, and you can tell there's a couple bulges in a couple of the spots that synergist builds holsters into their coats and stuff. So he's definitely packing some heat. He has his eyes done. It's a full cyber eye look, but I'm trying to think of like a subtle twist on it. Probably like it looks like a normal human eye, except where the iris would be colored, it's like chrome. So not like the full chrome eye. It just looks like at a glance like he's got light blue eyes, you know. But yeah, it's actually a metallic thing to it. And some subtle chrome sticking out a little. But nothing super duper obvious under the suit.
So we got a whole bunch of guys that are all like, I've got chrome, but nothing obvious.
The dangerous kind.
All right. So, Bull looks at you, goes, gentlemen, he goes, for this job, I'm going to be partnering you up with a gentleman who's new to the shadows. Chris met him a couple weeks ago. I believe he wants to go by the name Quick Root now. So...
Well, yeah, don't we all have code names in this thing? I thought that was, like, the standard operating procedure. You know, I mean, come on.
It's entirely up to you.
So he's that new?
No, I know how to handle myself. I got pulls out a Ares Predator from somewhere, like under the table.
The tag's still hanging off the bottom of it.
Got a gun? Yeah, it's not loaded. There's no clip in it.
All right, he's convinced me now. I feel great about this. Not worried at all.
Yeah. Mikey is assuming he has been hired to balance out Quick Route at this point. It's like,
I'm just giving him the most shit-eating grin.
Yeah, so unfortunately, Quick Route was burned by his former company recently.
Well, we don't like to say burned. We like to say alternatively let go.
Yeah, they tried to kill you.
They had taken action.
Tomato, tomato. You know.
The old aggressively disavowed.
Yes.
A little bit.
So he is now looking for alternative lines of work. So sure. I figured he's got some affinity for technology and such, so I hooked him up with a little bit of gear, and we're going to get him started here. So hopefully you guys don't mind partnering up with him for this run. We'll test him out and see how he does.
Do you have your own armor this time?
Oh, yeah. Got it. He opens up his armored vest and starts pointing out all the different features of it, and then he points to a part and goes, oh, I shouldn't tell you about that part.
Yeah. Tooth looks at Bull with a, what did I do?
Was I bad?
This is because I trust you, gentlemen.
The sad part is I know what I did.
what's really sad is that Pomeranian ain't here. Yeah, unfortunately, she had other engagements tonight, apparently.
Lucky girl.
Actually, I think she just couldn't find a ride. From the pile of barons.
It's a good place for a young lady to live.
Well, you know, it's when you have a squatter lifestyle and no vehicle.
You must be a mage.
Pretty much.
Or normally a shaman, I would say, but.
All right. So anyways, now that you guys have all introduced yourselves, let me introduce you to. You're Mr. Johnson for this run.
I give Bull this look. Is it her or someone else?
Her. Okay. Oh, no. It's this gentleman right here. Oh. You remember there was three people in the room. He's like, the guy
that looks like a Johnson sitting next to him. That's
yeah,
the guy.
That's the guy one. I mentioned.
My apologies, I forgot.
Has a name tag that says M. Johnson.
I don't have a picture for him because I didn't think that I forgot to grab one for him ahead of time. So,
plus, I don't think you can find a guy with that much leg showing.
Well, he doesn't dress like her. Jesus.
And two.
So, the Mr. Johnson.
Yes. Mr. Johnson goes, gentlemen, my name is Derek Erding. Because I have a favor to ask of you. Says, a couple of months ago, my daughter, she got herself involved with some unsavory types and has gone missing. She ran away from home. She turned 18, and she thinks she knows everything now. And, you know, she's declared herself an adult, and she thinks she knows what's best. And unfortunately, what she decided was best was hooking up with some street gutter scum, some gangbanger in the area.
I think it's a raised eyebrow.
I don't think she really understands what she's doing. She's never been away from home or around elements like that, so I can understand why it's, you know, new and different, but it's also incredibly dangerous, and I'm very, very concerned about my daughter. Unfortunately, I don't have a whole lot of information other than the name of the gentleman she is dallying with, and that he is a member of one of the local street gangs. I would like you to track her down and convince her to return home.
What's her name?
Her name is Amelia. and her boyfriend's name is, he goes by the name of Brass Tiger. Go figure.
And you guys thought my street name was bad. I mean, come on.
I do have Seattle Street Gangs. Is there even a remote chance I would recognize that name?
There's always a remote chance.
All right. I'll throw in on that, too. I believe I have street.
Go ahead and roll. Tell me how many hits you get. Yeah.
While he is racking his brain to try and think of that, does he know what gang Brass Tiger is in?
Yes.
Oh, he does? Okay.
Yep.
I thought you said he didn't know. All right, I got three successes.
Now, he doesn't know a whole lot about him. He doesn't have any street knowledge. He tells you he's not even from Seattle originally. You got how many?
Three.
Did anybody else roll?
I tried.
Okay.
Ness made an attempt.
The name itself does not ring any bells. But he tells you that the he tells you that he runs with a gang, some small time gang, that calls itself the Mercer Street Mercenaries.
Ugh.
He said, as far as I know, they're not a very big street gang, but they operate somewhere out of downtown Seattle.
So with that roll, with those three successes, three hits, does that ring a bell, the Mercer Street Mercenaries?
It does not.
Okay.
They're apparently a very small time. Does anybody have area knowledge, though? Seattle area knowledge.
I have a knowledge of Seattle at very high, but that was, it just, it was the generic city was all I have.
All right. Well, you can go ahead and roll.
I have it as well.
Go ahead and roll. All right.
So I got five.
All right. Dan got two, three. All right. Yes, you guys both recognize, you know that there is a Mercer Street. It's north of, it's in downtown Seattle. North a little ways of, well, more or less where you're at now.
It's about three blocks north of the Space Needle.
So it's like in downtown?
Yes.
Yeah, kind of heart of downtown, looks like.
Yeah, it's about a mile north of, about a mile north west of Pike Place. So that might be a start.
That is the good thing about street gangs that put the name of their street in the name of their gang.
Indeed.
And,
very helpful.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, we'll be sure to thank him for that.
So, he says, in exchange for recovering her, I am willing to offer up 100,000 New Yen for the group. So, like I said, I am quite concerned for my daughter, and I would like her returned in one piece before she gets herself in too much trouble.
How long has she been gone?
2 weeks.
2 weeks. What if she doesn't want to come back?
Convince her to come back.
You want us to convince her to come back, or do you want us to bring her back? Because those are two different types of jobs.
Well, there is that. I would prefer you convince her.
And if that doesn't work, bring her back? Is that what you want?
Yes. Well, no, better not. If it doesn't work, at least get her location and let me know where she's at and what she's doing so that I can maybe, I'll consider my options at that point.
All right, so you want us to find her, talk with her, try and convince her to come back, and if that doesn't work, then contact you with any information we have at that point.
Yes.
What about the boyfriend?
Probably best, he sighs, probably best not to harm him. I'm not fond of the, I don't think he's worth her, but not worth alienating her over. Don't want her thinking daddy hired a hitman to whack her boyfriend.
Yeah, that would be ridiculous.
We don't have to mention your name.
She'll know.
All right, just checking.
So, do what you can.
All right.
All right.
All right. Would it be the time when we negotiate?
this would be the time to negotiate.
All right, I will make a negotiation roll here. Unless someone else has got negotiation skills that wants to step in here, but that's my thing.
So, he had tooth at 100,000, so you're it's all on you.
Yeah, Mikey's like, yeah, I need like 5,000 a month. Yeah, no, we're good. Yeah, that's fair.
Especially since I think we could maybe just not do the job. Tell him we did, and maybe get paid.
Okay. Okay, Mike is not also thinking that part. That part, I am not thinking.
I'm definitely not saying it out loud.
Obviously.
All right. Go ahead, and if you're going to want to negotiate, go ahead and make a charisma plus negotiation roll.
All right. Adding up here.
Tell me how many hits you get.
I got 8 hits.
You got 8 hits?
8 hits.
Damn.
Wow, that's higher than my limit.
You know, I almost hit the limit. I got a limit of 9.
That is double my social limit.
It's what I do. I may not be good at other things, but this I can do.
All right. Keith's ready to do it for half the price.
Oh, real good.
He thinks a moment and he goes, that's fair. Like I said, she does mean a lot to me. Why don't we say 120,000?
The rest of us who were already on board are like, yeah, no, that works.
I look around to make sure everyone's on board before I say yes, because if people are shaking their heads no, then don't go ahead and say yes right away. Otherwise, I'll accept.
Mikey has done this sort of job for years just like as part of his salary. So actually getting paid just for the job instead of it just being something that some executive mentions in passing, right? He's like, fuck yeah, yeah.
He's got the same thing. It's like he does it for people around the neighborhood all the time.
I'm watching Bull. I'm ready to see if he's reacting at all, because last time he underpaid me.
But yeah, Mike is like, shit, you know, 20K for this? Hell, I'll go kidnap him a new daughter for that. 20,000 apiece, we'll get you a new one.
It's Amelia 2.0.
Yeah, we could do that for way cheaper than 120K.
Well,
shit, we're in the underground. If you take an orc kid, probably find a family that would pay you to take it. You know.
Wow.
Now, Mikey will he'll kind of raise. He won't raise his hand, but he'll do like that corporate businessman thing where he just kind of lifts a few fingers to get some attention. He'll go, what about any upfront expenses? Because I'm thinking if we can't get her to come with us, maybe you could stay in touch with her if you give her a gift of a comm link. And maybe Quick Root here does some shit to the comm link.
That's not a terrible plan.
That way we've got a way to get a hold of her. She gets a fancy new toy. We got a bug on the thing. Whatever.
He's like, that's fair. Makes sense.
Standard exact recon sort of thing.
He pulls out a comm link and whoop. He sends over to Dash, and Stash was doing the primary negotiating. Dash, your comm link blinks, and would you like to accept a transfer of 20,000 new yen?
Yes, I would.
No, he doesn't want that.
No, I'm going to pass on that.
Oh, my God. All more right. Spam, swipe.
Wow, I got an email. This Tier Tangier Prince has all this gold he wants to transfer.
Back Quinn, right.
He's like, please help with my family's Orichalcum mine.
He just can't get it out of Portland. It's tough.
Who's your Tier Tangier Prince that you were writing a plane with? What's his name?
Which, me?
Yeah.
All of them.
Well, okay. Yeah. Blackwing.
Honestly.
What's his
name? Yeah, Evan Paris.
Paris, that was it. Yes. I was blanking on his name.
Prince.
Yeah, you guys turn it down. I'm the GM. He's whatever I want to call him. He's my puppet.
No, his name is Prince Paris.
All right, Prince Paris just had a dragon drop on him.
Yeah.
He's dead in my game.
He dodged.
Nope, he's dead. It's terrible.
He's immortal
in the cannon.
All right. I might be able to convince Jason to let me kill him. No, man. I'm just kidding.
All right, so we've got some upfront payment.
You got some up pay.
And the upfront payment was just the extra we extorted from him. So that's good. Mikey's ready to go.
Yeah, Tooth is sitting there doing his best to not make any facial expressions. That's how he contributes to negotiation.
that's usually the best way the brick characters can contribute.
Yeah. Don't he tries to keep his eyebrows from climbing up his face.
Quickly up there, pushing him back down.
Exactly.
It's like 120,000 UCAS new.
Yeah. It's not Bitcoin again, is it?
Yeah.
British pounds.
Oh, too soon.
I take it we will accept
really hard not to make any facial.
Yeah.
He did just give us $20,000.
Right.
I think it's a little late for us to say, no, this job sounds bad. And like,
what's the lying ball going, what the hell?
I think once you take the advance, you're kind of locked in.
We have contact info for him when we have information to share with him.
He taps his comlink again and dash. You get another file. Because, again, you were kind of you're the charming one, apparently. You get a little download file sent over to you.
Okay.
A data file. It's got a contact number, and it's got a picture. And the picture is of a girl, late teens, auburn hair, very pretty, green eyes.
Human,
stylish. Yeah, he's human, she's human. Very stylish looking.
Anything else you could think of that might help?
Unfortunately, no. We came to town to visit. I was in town on business. I brought her with me. She just recently graduated high school, and she went out to a nightclub or something. And the next day, she told me that she'd met some guy and she was in love and. She wanted to marry him and was going to be with him the rest of the life and told me about him being this awesome gang member. And
Oh, I've heard of this. It's that mental thing.
Being a teenage girl?
Yeah, that.
Do you have her comlink number?
Yes. Unfortunately, that won't help you. Because her comlink is currently sitting in the apartment that we were renting. So... Yes, I told her not to get involved with this guy in no uncertain circumstances, and the next morning she was gone.
There's your problem.
Well, she's always been an obedient girl in the past.
Sorry.
So
you know what club she met him at?
Not sure. I don't remember.
So if you've got her comlink, would you be okay with us maybe taking a peek around?
We want to look at her selfies.
There might be this brass tiger's contact information.
Or if she had her comlink on her when she met him, there might be more up-to-date pictures of him. Could be GPS stuff about where they met or where he's taken her since then.
That's a good idea. You know. I will have it. I'll have it delivered here to the club, right here for Bull, and then you guys can get it. That sounds good.
Thank you.
All right. He says, I'll have that. In fact, hold on. He makes a comlink call. Yeah? Yeah, can you get Alicia's, what did I say her name was? Amelia. Thank you. I really should write this stuff down. You'd think me recording it would help.
I'm starting to be on her side. I mean, he doesn't remember her name.
What are you talking about? Parents call their kids by each other's names all the time.
That's the dog's name.
By the cat's name on a kid.
Fetch me the comlink for daughter one.
Yeah. Hey, John, do I have a daughter? Yeah, get her comlink. Yes. Yeah. Please deliver it to the gold mine in the Orc Underground. Yes, as soon as possible. Okay. Thank you. Says it'll be here in an hour.
Well?
Are we planning on waiting for it to get here?
That's up to you. Says, gentlemen, if there's nothing else, I do have other pressing business I need to take care of. But I do hope that you're able to find her as quickly as possible.
And where do you want us to bring her when we get a hold of her? If she comes with us?
Oh, I'm staying at the Mulvihill Hotel downtown here. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I'll be at the Mulvihill if you guys need me. And you guys have my contact information. Call me as soon as you, if you get her or whatever, find out information, call me, let me know, and then I can meet you there or whatever. Any other questions? Good. Anything else?
Yeah, Bull, you promised me a drink.
Are you talking to me or the NPC?
I'm talking to the GM who's on the other side of the state. Give me my drink. All right,
I will get you one at Origins next year.
There you go. Perfect.
Bull so, looks at you and goes, get a drink, Jesus. Go order something.
Thanks. All right.
The bar, don't pull something.
He kind of tries, he does the, he's in the middle of the seat, right? So he does the little scooch over thing, to get over to the head. He brings the nearest
cool
head, goes, whispers something. Waiter just kind of gives him a look and walks off.
I think that'll be all, unless anyone else has anything. All
right. He kind of...
Is it looking like that Johnson's going to leave and Bull's going to stay?
The Johnson's leaving. Bull will stay for a few minutes at least. Ask you if you have any other questions once he's gone. So the Johnson leaves.
While the Johnson's leaving, I'm going to just start a... It takes a little bit of time, but I'm going to start a matrix search on the Brass Tiger and on him. Anything I can find about him and his daughter, just to kind of back up the story.
All right. Yes, make me two much. Matrix tests. It's whatever the matrix search is.
Computer and intuition.
Okay, go for it.
And yes, for all you kids out there who are playing 5th Ed, always leg the Johnson.
Of course.
Always do your homework.
That's not addition specific.
No, you're right. You're right. But I mean, in terms of, all we did is run 5th Ed, and at Origins, I ran 3 sessions. Not a single person thought to.
I wouldn't do that at a convention either.
Yeah, in large part, I think some of that comes down to convention expectations,
yeah.
As opposed to change. Because when I wrote missions, you didn't get betrayed by Mr. Johnson because there just wasn't time to tell a story and have a betrayal.
Well, so, as I play in a convention, I will blunder into everything as much as possible.
Yeah, it's going to be one of two things is going to happen. A, he's not planning to betray you anyways, or B, he's going to betray you and it's part of the story, so that's going to happen regardless.
The leg isn't going to help much. Good point.
I can at least take steps.
Oh, no, in this game, you should definitely do that.
Oh, yeah, you should definitely, question everything.
Yeah, the only reason we didn't question Bull is because, we were elves, so.
Yeah. It wouldn't have helped anyways, because Bull wouldn't have known any better for last game.
Wait, Bull.
Yes.
Where's the reliable and reputable electronics dealer down here in the underground? Since we got an hour to kill waiting for that comlink to get delivered, we go buy a halfway decent comlink to give the girl in case she wants that one instead.
Oh.
Pretty sure it'd be Bull.
That's why he's asking.
But,
I'll do computer work, but I don't usually I don't keep parts and stuff. I don't stock the hardware.
Yeah, not looking for some knockoff joint, but just someplace we can buy our halfway decent, maybe something by Erica. Girls like Erica, right? I don't know.
Amelia. What?
Erica's the name of a comlink company.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
Yep.
Nokia. Oh, what?
Yes, they want
the one.
You want to get the
quick
report. You want to get the Tiffany.
That's the EM Neonet. I was trying to remember that was.
No,
Sam.
You guys are going about it all wrong. She's going to the streets. She wants something that's street.
All right. Yeah. He can hook you up. He knows a guy.
So how much we want to spend on this, fellas?
Just go with book prices. So.
Well.
because Bull's recommending us, so this guy's not going to upcharge you anything.
That's well, my question. It's the easy math on the upfront, like 2,000, is 3,000 new yen apiece and 2,000 for expenses. Right? I mean, just to me, like that's the quick math for that.
Can we
but,
get a decent yeah. comlink for the 2K extra there?
That's
the
what I was thinking. Well, there's an MCT Blue Defender in Data Trails that, out of character, I think might appeal to like a wannabe ganger chick. And that it's well, it,
no,
it comes,
my character would definitely recommend the Blue Defender because he was responsible for part of the kernel.
He was,
so.
Yeah. But it, it's
the Blue Defender. It's because she wants her to be safe, or he wants her to be safe.
Well, right, and the Blue Defender is a it's a it's a stylish bracelet, but B it's sold to like security groups and stuff. It's got a better than normal firewall, but it's like designed as like a bracelet thing. But
how,
you know, since it's the one that.
Availability
7, 2,000 bucks. Just out of character, metagaming it as we're having a conversation like on the way to the shop.
All right.
But I'm thinking it's, that's the even 2,000.
Is everybody going to the shop or is anybody staying back at the bar?
I'm staying back.
Yeah. Doing my third.
Okay.
I just figured a couple go to the shop, a couple stay at the bar, but
I'll go with the shop.
All right.
Yeah, and this one is quote, off-the-books distribution to Shadowrunners and criminals worldwide. So I'm thinking it's one that might appeal to a wannabe ganger chick.
That's why I bought it.
Yeah. And plus
you're
it's
a wannabe ganger
a,
chick?
That's right. You got
plus
it. I'm an elf.
Plus it's got Firewall 5. So it's actually not like a terrible, you know,
no,
comlink.
It sounds fine. And if you're communicating all this through the comlink, I have no problem throwing that in. I'm going to stay, however, at the place where I'm
and,
not going to get if he looks.
And to be fair, he's sitting there like on his comlink going, 2,000. Hey, how about this Blue Defender thing? You know, like he's looking stuff
yeah.
up and, you know.
I figure if I'm going with the troll, I might not stand out so
all
much.
Right. You guys are heading over there. Dan, were you going with him, or were you staying at the bar?
Quickroot is torn because he always heard you don't split the party.
As long as you keep a troll on each place, you're okay.
Yeah, that's the, that's Dungeons and Dragons.
Oh yeah, because splitting
the party all the time.
Yeah, okay. As long as you're next to a troll, you're on base.
All right, well, I'm going to go with the troll that's going to go get the hardware then.
All right,
you guys are walking down, and. We're going to assume that the Quick Root, you still haven't entirely broken all your hardware in, and you're still, because, you know, you still think like a good corporate wage slave.
Oh, yeah.
So you haven't quite gotten your comm link to the point where it's not giving you, you know, news alerts and all that fun stuff all the time.
Oh, yeah. Full of bloatware still. I haven't rooted it.
So your comm link beeps. It kind of gives you that little doo-doo-doo-doo. Like special alert message, you pop it up, and it's a special alert, and you remember you've gotten a number of these over the last couple of days. This is probably the fourth or fifth one about gang violence going on in town in Seattle, like more than normal. It seems like a couple of the larger street gangs have been clashing over territory, and it's been getting more and more violent.
Because it's a day that ends in day.
Well, yeah. Like I said, this is unusual.
But it's been enough to make the news, yeah.
Yes, it's like we're talking like 30-40 gangers, you know, out in the open in downtown Seattle with, you know, machine guns and rocket launchers.
Mm.
Whoa.
Yeah.
In actual downtown?
In actual downtown.
Hey, Kenny, he's falling down on the job. I actually say that. I actually say, wow, KE's really been falling down on the job.
KE's been... You're guessing by the number of these you're getting, KE's getting a little pressed thin.
Yes.
So
good. Makes our jobs easier.
Something's going on and you don't know what.
So, Quick Root, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My name.
Yeah. Just stay behind me, okay?
I can, but... What happens if they come from behind?
Then I turn around to kill them, and you move so that you're still behind me.
Oh, okay. No, makes sense.
All right. Sam, Ness.
Yes?
You were making data search tests.
Yes.
What was your your first test was for?
The father-daughter.
The father-daughter.
That flipped. You said the first one was tiger and the second one was father-daughter.
Doesn't matter. Yes, just choose. Right, okay. Yeah, it doesn't matter whichever one you wanted to do first.
Four successes for tiger. Brass tiger.
How many successes?
Four?
Okay. You don't really find anything on him. He does not seem to be a major player in the street gang scene, as far as you can tell.
All right.
Because he doesn't pop up in the Shadowrun who's who of street gangs.
There's this guy named Iron Monkey.
Really savvy online blogs, journals.
What was that?
Sappy online blogs. He's got his MySpace page.
Even or odd?
Neonet 2.1.
Odd.
He actually does have a P2 account.
Nice.
He hasn't posted to it in a while.
Okay.
But you do find some stuff, and it looks like it was before he got heavily into. It was you could see mostly it was like from high school and stuff before he got into the street gang.
Covered in heavy metal and cat pics.
Yes.
And of course, heavy metal cat pics.
Yes.
Yes.
Favorite band, the Grunge Kid.
He does have a picture that was posted a couple of days ago to it.
Okay.
Of him, and it looks like a picture of Amelia.
Aha.
What's that?
The image. So I have a reference.
Okay. Yeah, it looks like the Mr. Johnson gave you a fairly recent picture of Amelia. And Brass Tiger is he's human looking. He's Hispanic. Shaved head, piercings. Kind of average looking, you know. I mean, not that, you know, whether. Don't know how much, you know, you're into judging guys by their appearance, but he's kind of average, and he's just wearing a leather jacket, and he looks kind of like your generic street ganger.
All right.
Nothing really standing out about him. But you do have a picture of him.
Yeah, no, that's excellent. What about the father-daughter?
All right.
Derek.
Okay, how many hits did you get on that one?
Six successes.
Six. All right. That's much better. All right. You do a little bit of digging. Derek Erding is the he is the CEO of a single A corporation out of New York, out of Manhattan. It's not a real big place. It looks like they dabble in a bunch of different areas, mainly tech. But you do find something interesting, though, but it goes back almost 20 years now.
Okay.
Him or somebody with the same name received a will bequest from Dunkelzahn.
Fudge.
Was
it a baby girl?
No.
Okay, just making sure.
No, it was... Well, this was 20 years ago, so she's only 18, he said. The request was for something referred to as the Red Dragon Banner. He requested it to somebody named Derek Erding. You don't know if it's the same Derek Erding or not. But that
significant.
Does
cool. All right.
Is it Erding or Erning?
Erding. E-R-D, as in Dove, Dan, David.
E-R-D?
E-R-D. ING. So.
All right. Well, that's significant. Potentially. Maybe. I'll,
Or it's a red herring.
Bum, bum, bum.
I get it because it's a red dragon banner.
Ness, any way you can, see if maybe you can figure out any information.
I'm sorry, not David, Derek.
Yeah.
So
the picture of the that was posted to the P2 account, Does it have, is it outdoors, indoors? Like, is there anything identifiable in the background? Can it be searched off of?
There's an ice cream truck in the background, right?
Yes. Damn. There's a burned out ice cream truck. He's dancing on
my luck.
Apparently they've acquired a familiar vehicle.
Familiar to who?
All right. As I note, and you needed six hits to find this, by the way, so just so you know. The specific will request is to Derek Erding, I leave the banner of the Red Dragon out of respect for his heritage. Use it well.
Oh.
So that's you guys. We're going to skip over to Mikey and Quickroot.
And Dash.
And Dash. You guys get to the shop, no problem. Like I said, it was just down the hall a little ways, down the tourist highway. You were told to give him Bull's name, and there was a passcode. Something about he hasn't lost an arm yet this week. You're not entirely sure what that means.
I don't want to know either.
But when you arrive at the shop, it is a dinky little junk shop, looks like. Just kind of literally a hole in the wall type shop. And there's kind of an older orc who's peddling his wares. And it's mostly electronic gear, but a lot of it looks like it's cobbled together stuff and junk that's been repaired. Kind of all secondhand stuff. But when you give him Bull's name, and I'm assuming giving him the passphrase?
Yep.
All right. When you do that, his eyes light up, and he motions to follow him, and he leads you into the back room. Once back there, he proceeds to pull guns and shoot you. No, I'm kidding.
Sweet.
End the mission. See you guys.
You guys go to the back room, and back there he has a lot more stock, and this stuff is actually all new and in packages. Most of it's in boxes that look like they came from Radio Hut or other places that is not this shop.
Right.
So probably not the most legal of items. But I'm sure you're not concerned about legality.
No.
Does he happen to have any MCT Galaxy 7s yet?
MCT Galaxy 7s.
Because those aren't supposed to be on the market yet.
Ah, okay. No, he doesn't have anything that's not out on the market. Do you guys specifically ask for the one... What was it again?
Yeah, the MCT Blue Defender. We'll just be like...
Blue Defender.
Yeah. Corporate Suit's daughter went missing. She wants to go slumming and play Ganger Joy Girl for a little bit. We're looking for something that a concerned father can give her to show that he's worried, and then also maybe we could put a back door in so that we could track the girl via it. Sort of thinking maybe something like a Blue Defender. It's supposed to have some Shadowrunner marketing guerrilla campaign stuff, right?
He kind of shrugs. I don't know. I just sell them. I don't worry about marketing. Oh, yeah. Hold on. He digs through the boxes a little bit. He pulls one out, sets it down, opens it up. Yep, got two or three of them here. You just want one?
Yeah, we just need one.
It's brand new in the package, still shrink-wrapped.
Got any with, like, a logo on them or anything?
Like, what kind of logo?
Something with a dragon? I don't know. I just got a text from the missus.
He looks really confused.
I am confused too, but I don't try not to look.
He goes, I don't really do that sort of work.
All right, no problem. We'll just take it.
All right,
we'll put an icon on it or something.
Oh, that's fine. I mean, if Bull sent you, he'd be the one to talk to about customizing the thing.
Yeah, we probably will.
All right, he goes. Since this is Bull, sell it to you at shelf price. So. Blah, blah, blah. What, $2,000?
Yep. Mikey will sidestep and open up the line of sight for Dash, who has the team funds.
I will send over the $2,000 to him.
All right. He will present you with the package.
Mikey gets alligator arms.
Yeah.
I can't reach my wallet.
Present him with the package.
Oh, no, I left my wallet at home. Can you handle this one?
Yeah. All right.
Hey, what's this guy's name?
This guy's name is, I don't know, James. His name's James.
A lot of James is in the underground. Jeez.
Yeah.
Very popular name of that generation.
Apparently.
All right, I guess we will head on back.
All right.
Tooth wanted to ask Bull, I don't know if you saw it, about if he knew anything about the Mercer Street mercenaries.
I did miss that.
See, that's why I was talking about
Dragon. Oh, hey, look at that.
Because it's other people haven't been paying attention to the chat.
For some reason, the chat's not scrolling for me. Seriously, it isn't scrolling down for some reason, so all I was seeing was the last... Somebody had rolled some dice last. That was the last I saw.
Hmm.
All right, so you wanted to... Oh, I see. That's where the message you got was. Like, you actually got a text. I don't know.
No, that was Mike.
I did all that assuming it would be on your feed.
Like I said, I don't know why it's not scrolling for some reason.
It's all good, man. So, it happens.
And it's a nice moment. I kind of like the fact that we can talk without disrupting you.
Oh, it's fine.
Yeah, I mean, that's what the chat is for, you know.
It is.
But yeah, it was
when the GM's,
funny.
You know, paying attention.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. You were asking about the gang, and you had street gang knowledge.
I do. I was just asking Bull if he happened to know anything, but I can roll it again.
No, Bull,
I got 3 hits the first time.
Oh, okay. But, yeah. No, Bull doesn't really know anything. He's not as into the gang scene.
Well, that's actually comforting to me because it means that they're basically extremely low-level players. At least that's Tooth's assumption.
Low-level enough to have a giant street war.
Well, we don't know yet that street war is associated.
Right.
The news articles, well, actually, nobody else has really picked up on this because Quick Root's the only one really paying attention to the...
that's what I've been operating on.
The news alerts.
Yeah.
I've been talking very loudly about them, but
yeah, and Mikey responded because you were just like, "Looks like Night Errant's not doing their job," and Mikey was like, "Sweet,
yeah."
That was as far as he. It's like, good. That makes our job easier. That was all he got from it. Yeah.
All right. Okay. So yeah, Bull doesn't really know a whole lot about them, but you know, Bull's not really a street gang type of guy. You want to know about famous Shadowrunners from the 50s, though? Bull's your man.
Or, you know, yeah, Matrix gangs or bug spirits. I mean, you can take it.
All right. So, the notes that we did not compare via comlink in the meantime, we are able to compare notes when we get back.
Yes.
Right.
All right.
So you guys get back. It took you about an hour all told to get down there and back because, like I said, it's not far, but it is crowded down here. And,
sure.
So you guys get back. It's been about an hour, and there is a package. Maxine's like, hey, you guys had something come for you.
Cool. We will take it with us to the back room.
Is it my shipment from Japan?
Yes.
No.
It's your Japan Amazon. Never mind. That didn't work nearly as well as
Japan
I thought. In my head, that was a better joke than what came out.
Well, I like Japan Amazon.
Hey, Bull, how long were they gone?
About an hour.
In that time, Tooth would have liked to go hit up Maxine.
All right.
She seems to be more in touch with kind of street-level stuff, is my understanding.
Hello there. Make a seduction roll. No,
well, this will go well.
You guys.
No. All right, you go talk to her a little bit. She knows a little bit about what's going on down here in the underground. Topside, she's not so much with. Much in touch.
Okay.
Yeah. She lives down in the underground here, and she pretty much. She knows a lot more about down here than up top. So.
All right. So. If all else fails, I say we just hit the streets and go to Mercer Street and look for these knuckleheads. Because any small-time 2-bit gang has to desperately flash their colors to hold on to whatever territory they got.
And a group of six people just walking in that no one recognizes? Yeah, you bet we're going to draw attention.
Bet. Well, kind of want
like
to.
Eight, because we do have patrols.
I'm not super worried about backlash from the Mercer Street mercenaries.
No.
But yeah, I'd say if we don't have any tips on the comlink that Dad just sent us, we just go to Mercer Street and find these guys. Because the whole thing with gangs is you got to flash your colors or the turf ain't yours. So we find somebody flashing Mercer Street Merc colors and ask him where to find Tiger. Ask Tiger where to find Amelia. Get Amelia, come home, and, you know, split.
Bada bing, bada boom.
What could possibly go wrong?
All right, question on that, the 18K remaining of our upfront money. You guys want 3K of that each right now, or you just want me to hang on to the 18 as it is?
Yeah, sure.
I'm going to do it. It's fine.
We can pony it up after we've done some work.
Yeah, at this point, just take the cut and...
Just to make sure we don't forget to do it, I'm going to put that tracer, drop a couple marks on the blue defender we got, so, and set up a little routine to be able to call, ping it.
Yeah, has anybody got like an RFID tag, a sensor tag?
I actually
or anything?
Do!
Because Mikey doesn't have the electronics, but Mikey is used to working people that have the electronics, you know, so like he's got a little bit of computer skill, it's just he's used to having like the corporate decker to do stuff. So he's just going to be like, all right, who wants to do a thing to that? You know, that's his level.
And they're going, I think what we need to do is leverage our
core competencies. Everyone stops.
Exactly.
Well,
so did somebody have a sensor tag or something to put it on it?
Well, I am a decker, so I can put a couple marks on it too.
Well, right. But I'm just, if we actually have the tag, we can give the tag frequency to the dad. So that he can constantly have the thing, because I don't think you can just transfer marks that way.
No, and
but,
unfortunately, marks only last as long as you're logged into the Matrix.
Yeah.
Okay. Reboot, you lose them. But tags are common. You can find them.
Yeah.
I mean, hell, you can pull a tag off another device.
If you guys want, we can say you could have picked up a couple from James.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, they're,
I have a set of them.
They're stupid cheap.
Too. Yeah, we're good.
All right, cool.
And Ness, do you want to roll on that, or
yeah? I mean, can Ness put some sort of like phone home app on there that's
just gonna? Yeah, I mean, security tag is 5 nuyen, and they can't get burned by tag erasers, so they're like the perfect ones for this sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So that's a nuyen a piece, you cheap fucks. You gotta.
Ness and I are going to be working on it.
We're not ponying up the whole thing
here.
You
know, hey. They might earn that by the end of the night. You never know.
But yeah, so Ness and Quickroot are able to open the case, put the tag in, close it up, all that good stuff.
Yeah, that's not a problem.
All right.
Okay. What about breaking the one the dad dropped off?
That is not a problem.
Yeah, I can break it. That's not a problem.
Broke. Snap. I don't know how this helps, but I did it.
And this is why we specified return versus bring back.
Tooth, that is why you cannot have nice things. We've had this talk before.
It's true.
You're like, look, you can see inside it now. Look.
All right. Yes, you can break it. It is not a problem. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like she actually used it for anything that the night, because she's got a lot of pictures and stuff like that to wade through. But if you go by date, it doesn't look like she has anything from the night the night before she left.
Right?
No records of previous communication, anything like that.
What's that?
No records of previous communication or anything?
No. Well, you know from what the dad... Yeah, there's nothing before that. You know from what the dad said that she met him at the club the night before she ran away, basically.
There's no, like, super emo text messages about how no one understands her and she's going to have to run away from home.
Come to those.
Well, she is a teenage girl.
Right. I mean, I assume those are there.
Are there references to a red dragon anywhere?
Not that you see.
If there aren't those emo texts, then maybe she's not.
There's an awful
teenage girl.
There's an awful lot of links to slash fiction in there, though. So.
And avoid that.
Actually, Quick Root would like the slash fic.
All right.
It's like I'm doing a psychological evaluation.
Yeah,
that's the ticket.
That's
for research only. Right. I'm serious.
So, all right. So we don't have a location from the comlink.
No.
The other comlink is ready to go if we want to give the girl the bait comlink to hopefully let Dad keep tabs on her and still fulfill our obligation. So, I say we roll up to Mercer Street.
It's only a couple miles, if I was reading that right?
It's less than 2 miles. It's a little over a mile.
Do we walk or do we take vehicles?
We might need to leave in a hurry with the girl. Yeah. So I'm thinking vehicles might be the way to go.
What kind of vehicles do people have?
I've got my motorcycle.
Yeah.
All I have is a bike, so that's not going to be all that helpful.
You guys are a recurring crew, so I kind of figured somebody had a GMC Bulldog
it
lying around.
Blew up!
They had an ice cream van.
That's good. So
it blew up.
Has anybody got a set of wheels that'll fit more than one by design? No?
The silence is deafening.
Fantastic.
All right.
I'm sure she'll fit on a scorpion.
Because I got a car, but it's a Metaway, and it's sized for a troll and some stuff.
His head kind of sticks out of the top as it is.
No, the Metaway is specifically designed for a troll, but it's what? It's for a troll. All right, so nobody else has a car.
I'm sure that most of the bikes can hold two, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Hey, Quick Group brought up a good idea. Any metadata on that image that we pulled from Brass Tiger's P2 account? Like location data, geotagging?
Yes. Mercer Street.
That was a little shot.
Let's go.
That makes it two things.
We published because we have source and confirmation.
Exactly. You're good to go. It's time to submit our work for a peer evaluation.
Exactly.
So,
look, at the very least, I'll grab my bike and I can, you know, bring it along with us.
All right.
And that'll at least let me be armed. Yeah.
So just saying, you know, in case the girl wants to go and the Mercer Street mercs don't want to let her go, somebody can get the girl and get out with her while the rest of us murder the Mercer Street mercs. That's kind of my thinking.
Well, we probably need to also organize a rendezvous point since we've apparently both parked at opposite ends of the Orc Underground. So,
yeah.
All right, so we're heading out.
Yeah.
Assuming
so let's.
We don't run into anything.
All right.
Because like Mercer Street seems to actually have like an end, right? I'm looking at. I'm just going by Google Maps here.
Yeah.
Because my assumption is we can do that in character also. So let's just meet at the end of Mercer Street by Fifth Avenue, which is the westernmost end of Mercer Street.
Yeah. Is there anything kind of neutral on that end, Bull? Maybe a stuffer shack or something we can meet at?
As we pull up our
you guys,
maps
well,
off.
Actually, you guys.
Right.
Well, because you guys did pull up the metadata.
Yeah.
I can give you the address on the metadata. Puts you near. It's near First Avenue in Mercer.
All right. So we'll meet there in 20 minutes or whatever. Does that sound good to everybody?
That's enough time, sure.
All right.
I'm going to jump into AR, just keep an eye out.
Okay.
So we're taking one vehicle, one bike?
Yeah, we don't.
Anyway.
Oh, no, I'm driving over there.
Yeah, I think we're just, we're going to all go get our disparate band of vehicles. And,
we're going to become a biker gang and invade
the saddest
gang.
Yes. Gang ever.
We're.
I'm gonna try to bum Tooth for a ride.
Sure.
Does anyone actually have the driving skill?
Yes.
They should probably be our getaway driver if it comes to that.
He is actually an expert, like, corporate security defensive driver guy with a ridiculous reaction score. It's just that he can't fit another person in his fucking car.
A slight flaw in that plan, then.
Yes. But, yeah, I mean, the thing officially says seats one, which is a little – it's a really weird car.
The Scorpion says it only seats one, too. I'm just assuming I can pick root on it.
The Scorpion's basically a hog. It has a bitch seat.
Right.
Yeah. Well,
all right, anyways.
Regardless.
Regardless, we'll assume somebody can take her.
But yes, we are all bringing vehicles, and if it comes down to it, the extra people can fit on the back of a motorcycle.
Yes.
And we'll be all right.
In the time-honored tradition of starting Shadowrun groups everywhere, we do not have the correct vehicles for the job.
No, that is always an issue.
There's always somebody taking the bus.
This group did have the correct vehicle. He destroyed it.
Well, to be fair, you didn't start the game with the correct vehicle.
Right.
You asked Bull to hook you up, which is why you ended up with an ice cream truck. So you guys are all taking your bikes? And or your overpriced troll mobile?
My single troll vehicle.
I'm hopping in the van. I heard there was a van.
No, there isn't.
No.
There isn't a van.
Get lifts on that just so that it actually goes down to the ground at an even level.
Yeah, when he gets out of it, it sits about 4.5 feet off the ground.
All right. Suspension is awesome.
All right, so you guys are each driving your own bikes or whatever. Just to confirm.
I'm gonna.
Yes.
With your permission, Bull, since you're my GM, I can get a comet, a Mercury comet with metahuman adjustment, for less than what I spent on my metaway. So can I retcon it to that car?
Yes, you can.
Because metahuman adjustment only costs $500 per seat. So I'm like, where did the money go on this?
I'm a little curious about that, and B, as a bigger dude, I can tell you it would cost a troll way more than $500 to get the vehicle modded.
I'm just saying, that's what metahuman adjustment, the cannon cost. So I'm just saying, I can get a Mercury Comet, install metahuman adjustment on all four of the seats, and have $2,000 in the bank, which, by the way, means I could pay for my medium lifestyle next month, and I don't need this job. So anyways, I'm gonna swap out that car and we'll be good.
That is perfectly fine.
Ness can ride in the back of Mikey's car.
Sweet.
And Mikey will volunteer to be tactical driver if that is needed. Just in general for the team. Because, like I said, he's actually, like I said, this the life module thing, he's pretty good at some things.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tooth will basically just kind of ride escort.
So we've got Mikey and Tooth and Nail. And if I remember right, Ness.
Yeah, Ness was riding with me.
Yep.
You guys had all parked down by the
Big Rhino.
Yeah.
Correct.
Dan,
I think Quickroot's coming with us though, because that's he's riding with us.
I'm on Tooth.
Okay, because you don't have a bike.
Yeah. Nope.
All right, that's fine.
Sure, you don't want to ride with Mikey in the car? Well, you're more than welcome either way.
Well, I don't know. I like the way he's just offering for on behalf of Mikey.
Yeah, you know.
You want to ride Mikey's car?
Mikey says he can drive. Yeah.
I was thinking a troll with an orc pose. Well, don't know he's an orc pose. But a troll with an orc would not leave much room for a small human.
I think he modified all four seats.
Yeah, the thing seats four.
Oh, that's right. We retconned you from a scooter to a sedan. That's right.
Okay.
It's a very
down
large,
right in the back.
It's a very it's basically a sedan that's sized up like an SUV.
Right. Well, exactly. Well, not only that,
it's like a crossover.
Exactly, and you're actually sitting in the back seat. So
there's really no trunk. That's just where the seats became.
Exactly.
Really quick tactical stuff. Anyone else set up their pans?
Mikey's got his own.
If you want to keep from getting your guns shut down or your eyes shut down, I can stick them in my pan and cover them with my firewall.
I think that sounds like a great idea.
I have a limited amount, so
I trust you implicitly.
He's actually rocking a pretty solid comlink, which AR interactions are a thing, but
let me know. I've got like 4 slots open.
So he's good. He's rocking his Hermes icon with a pretty strong firewall and stuff. So he will let others take point on taking you up on that.
Cool.
I am a rigger, so I will always take more firewall.
Actually, your firewall is probably better than mine.
No, he's kind of got a throwaway CR. What did I get him? Because again, this is basically the character is basically built with the idea that he's got nothing but hand-me-downs from Bull.
He's basically gotten what Bull has been able to cobble together in less than 2 weeks.
So he just has like a chest full of arms.
Yeah, exactly.
Just they gave him like a footlocker. Just
this is the arm that explodes. Yeah. This is the arm that has the Ares Alpha in it.
Yeah.
Poor Bull. All right. Okay. So the other two, you guys are kind of going around Christoph and Dash, if I remember right. You guys came through the Lorshams. So you guys are kind of going the long way around.
The idea of avoiding the big rhino to avoid the incidents with the orcs, that seemed to have backfired.
Yeah, actually, Pike Place is actually on First Avenue. You guys hit the road. Dash and Chris, you arrive with very little instances. We'll get to you guys.
We're screwed.
The rest of you.
Yeah.
You're cutting up through, like I said, you kind of cut up through First Avenue, and that kind of goes through the Pike Place Market area. You guys are just crossing Stewart Street. When up ahead, which is the corner of Virginia and First Avenue, there is an explosion.
Okay.
Way to go, guys.
Text the troll I'm not with and say, what did you do?
All right. So is Ness and Quick Root both riding with Mikey? Was that what I got?
Yeah. I think that's what was.
And Tooth is acting as your outrider.
Exactly. Yeah, right.
Okay.
I was going to be like, hey, Tooth, do you want to be in front or behind the car? And then there was explosions. He'd be like, no, I'm behind. I'm like a block, block or two away.
In fact, you decided you'd run patrol for the elves, right?
Well, yeah, we'll make sure they get there safe, sure.
I'm so sleepy. I'm just going to go home, guys.
You were actually up front.
Cool. All right. Sounds like me.
So you actually see this a little ahead of Mikey. It's not a huge explosion. It's not like, you know.
But
there is an explosion.
Even a
small
one. Not
the opening of Die Hard 3.
I guess I slow down.
You slow down, and that's a good thing, because as you slow down, you see what appears to be a city bus flip to its side and go skidding to a halt, across the road.
I wonder if those two things are related.
Nothing gets past you, Mikey. Nothing gets past you.
Total coincidence. Over the roar of your motorcycle, as you're slowing down a little bit, you hear gunfire from up ahead.
Small arms or something bigger?
Hard to tell at this point.
Okay. I just kind of look back at Mikey.
It's about a half block up.
Want to go around or go through? How far from where we're supposed to meet Dash and Chris are we?
You're pretty good ways away still.
Okay.
You're not far from here. Hold on, actually.
He will glide to a stop behind you, assuming that we swapped comlink information and stuff. He'll just turn on like the hands free call, so all of us in the car can holler at Tooth. You know what I mean? Just he'll just do like the hands free dashboard thing, and he'll just be like
on the map there. See the little martini glass?
Yes.
The martini glass is actually the gravity bar, in case anybody was wondering why that was there. It's one of the bars out of the Seattle book. But that road running right next to it, to the left of it, that's the road you're on, and you're just off the map is where you're at right now.
Okay.
So the Mercer's still, like I said, almost a mile away from here. So you got a little ways to go yet.
So all Mikey right. will just go, hey, you're on point. You make the call.
Is the bus blocking the road?
It's blocking about half the road.
Is it going to be a problem for the car to get through?
You're not sure yet.
Oh.
Yeah, it's up ahead a little further. You haven't gotten quite close enough. Traffic is, of course, you know, grinding to a halt around here, though. So.
Right. Is there traffic in front of us? Or is
A little bit. You might be able to get past it, but you're not 100% positive.
What about going around or turning back? Is that going to be possible?
Yeah, you could probably turn. Yeah, you can turn back and cut across. It's a city, so there's all kinds of roads.
Okay, then I'll probably swing back around.
All right.
It looks like that's going to be an easier path.
Okay. You guys turn around, head back over to Stewart Street and cut up a couple blocks and then head over. Head over to 3rd Street and cut up.
Cool.
Yeah, you don't know exactly what's going on, but there's some sort of gunfire going on.
I mean, it's Seattle, so, you know.
Yeah.
It's not terrible odds of some sort of disturbance, especially if we heard on the news that Knight Errant is getting overwhelmed, so.
Yeah. You're about half a block away, and as you're kind of going up, you see a couple of Knight Errant Lancers come screaming past you.
Good. The other direction, or?
Heading down towards where you just came from.
He will let his grid guide ease him to one side so that they can get by, and, you know.
Yeah, grid guide's map's lighting up with, this route is obstructed. This route is now obstructed. Please take alternate route.
Explosions. 5-minute delay.
Damn it.
They would program Green Grind with that.
They would have to. I mean, it's, you know.
Common enough. So.
Perception check. Test to see if there's in the direction that all those explosions came from.
Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
As you guys are turning around, you can kind of, you're looking out the back window, kind of going, what's going on?
Oh, what's that?
Do you have any
Tooth's more put out by the delay in traffic than anything else.
Yeah, it's a visual perception test, so if you have any kind of visual mods. And if you have, it'll be a little easier if you have vision mag of any kind. I don't know if you have goggles or cyber eyes or what all.
I have some sunglasses with vision mag.
There you go.
But I was talking about a matrix perception. I'm looking for icons.
Oh, there's icons everywhere. Yeah, you'll need to be more specific.
All right, weapon icons from that direction.
Yes. There's a bunch of them.
There's a few fewer of those.
Pistol launcher icons from that direction.
There you go.
Yeah, there's definitely some weapon icons. You don't even need to make a test. You can see those.
Okay.
Question is, can you see if they're loaded or not?
Well, then he'd have to start hacking them.
Indeed.
And you're rapidly getting further and further away, so it's up to you if you want to. It's up to you if you want to mess around.
Nah.
Yes, you want your. Well, only if you want to use wireless, like SmartLink or anything like that.
But yes, you want your individual stuff slaved to your pan.
Yeah.
Via comlink.
If you're not using any electronic stuff like that, you can have it disabled, and I don't care if you disable it. That's fine with me.
Mikey's stuff is all on, just officially.
Or if you want to go old school and actually have a plug, then you don't need to have it wireless. But
Mikey is not afraid of this wireless new future.
Yeah, Tooth's are all turned off because it's not really going to do much for him.
You don't have a smart link or anything?
Nope.
Okay, then. Yeah, that's not going to do much for you. I mean, you could always, you know, have your phone, your gun tell you the weather and, you know, the curve, you know, whatever.
I mean, he hasn't turned on his comm. It just doesn't go any further than that.
All right.
Siri, what is that gunfire?
That all is right. The sound of progress, my friend.
Exactly.
Okay. All right. Yeah, actually, Ness, as you're driving away, you actually see a lot of unusual Matrix icons from back there. There's an inordinate amount of cybernetic Matrix icons.
Oh. I'm gonna speak up to the group, say, hey, got a lot of hardware back there, a lot of chrome.
It's not Aaron's problem now.
I speed up a little bit.
All right.
What did you guys do?
You guys get around, and it's not a problem.
I would like to throw a mark on one item just to be able to tag it and keep track of it and see if we come across it at any point. Just I'm going to pick one at random.
Okay. Keep in mind that once you – because you have to log into the net to do that. Keep in mind once you have a mark on, you have to stay logged in. And there is a time limit before God finds you.
Oh, you're right. Never mind.
Yeah.
You can't leave marks up because as soon as you do an attack or a sleaze, God starts counting.
Yep.
Who thought up that acronym? Because holy shit.
The new Matrix rules weren't designed to be subtle.
Yeah. Nope, I forgot. That's a good point.
Well, yeah, Grid Overwatch Division had been in the game since FASA days. To some degree or another, they just weren't the global force that they are now.
Yeah, and there was no such thing as convergence on a player.
No. Well, you guys get up to Mercer Street without too many problems. You will still beat the elves there, because you're going, like I said, you're going a little bit more of a direct way, whereas they had to kind of go up and around a little bit. Mercer Street's actually a fairly decent neighborhood. There's a lot of shops and stuff through here. A number of apartment buildings. It's not a real... This particular area is a little more, like I said, a little more commercial and residential. Not heavy with, like, corporate buildings or sky-rises and stuff like that.
Once we kind of pull into the parking spot... I'll do a quick call to Dash just to make sure they're still clear.
All right.
So we're talking, it's probably about 11 o'clock at night by now.
Yes.
Right? Meet started at 9.
Yeah.
Meet started at 9. We blew at least an hour. So, that's late enough and dark enough that the gangers, if they exist, will come out. So, while we're sitting and waiting for them to come meet us, he's just going to take a look. Like, are we at the club? Where are we? This location that we got from the comlink picture.
It's actually just on, because the picture was just taken out on the, looks like just out on the street.
Okay.
It's out on a corner. There is a, it looks like a restaurant right near, there's actually several restaurants right around here. There's a couple restaurants and a couple of bars.
He's going to take a look at the bars just on his comlink. Like, just pull up, Yelp. And he's going to look through, like, the comments on the bars and look for anybody low-starring it, complaining about a bunch of thugs hanging around, that sort of thing.
Okay. Make me a computer test.
Yeah, so we're going to...
Just a computer plus logic.
Logic. So, got a hit.
You got a hit. You fumble around a little bit with it because you're not as familiar, but you there is a bar called T.S. McHugh's about a block and a half up the road.
Good.
There is actually a comment from Brass Tiger complaining about slow service.
Sweet. so we know he's been there at least the once. He will share that with Quickroot and Ness.
Just right. As we're people chatting never lie on Yelp.
Yeah. Hey, Bulldrek.
Yeah. Yelper.
Yeah. Whatever the Shadowrun equivalent of Yelp is.
Yeah.
Bull, while he's doing that, is there any like I don't think we have any symbols of the gang's iconography, but do we have like is there like obvious graffiti? Is like one piece of graffiti over another? What does it look like in terms of, you know, gang signs, I guess?
There's a little bit of graffiti through here, but not a terrible lot.
Any predominant symbol?
Nothing that you see.
Go away?
Nothing that you see.
Toya. Hey, Ness.
Yo.
I just found a login that Brass Tiger uses to complain about this was it a bar, this one? Sorry, Bo.
T.S. McHugh's, the bar.
Yes,
the bar. He used it to complain about this bar. Maybe you want to see if you can find him complaining about other places up and down the street, or find a place that he praises or something, because maybe we can narrow down the number of night spots we got to come visit tonight.
Sure. I'll cross-reference the local restaurants and...
All right. Are you guys just sort of parked out here? Kind of pulled up to the curb and just kind of hanging out?
Yeah, I mean, I checked in with Dash. How far out are they?
Oh,
what are you doing with the car?
They're almost there.
Takes a while.
Yeah, I would have given we just pull into a parking lot.
Yeah, I would have pulled into the parking lot of like a restaurant or something in the area.
There is a Taco Bell a couple of blocks away.
Against my better judgment, I'll pull into that parking lot.
Well, in the future, all the restaurants are Taco Bell.
Oh, sure. And that is Maxine's second favorite movie after Cobra.
Oh, okay.
Is Demolition.
Yes, yes, it is.
And The Mystery of the Three Seashells.
Good morrow, Jen's part. Well, do we want to be super obvious and draw them out, or do we want to do investigation? Do we want to be subtle about this, or is this just a snatch and grab?
Well, he wants, and number one, we don't want to hurt the primary.
Well, of course.
So we don't want to start a fight with the girl there if we can help it. But I figure we walk in, we let her know her dad's worried about her. Dad wants to talk to her. Dad wants her out of here. And then we see what Brass Tiger has to say about that and take it from there, basically.
I was going to say, her dad didn't want him permanently injured. That doesn't mean we can't scare him.
Doesn't mean we can't temporarily injure him.
Well, yeah, I mean, just dad's not paying for him to be permanently injured.
Right.
I mean, but
why don't we hop in one of these places and just kind of stake it out a bit while we're
staking it out?
Taco Bell is still open.
Taco Bell.
So we're at Taco Bell. Let's do a quick search, see which one he frequents.
Oh, sorry. What was the Aztec place we were talking about on the freelancer list?
It's Taco Temple.
Taco Temple, that's what it was. This is Taco Temple. Tastes so good, you'll sacrifice your taste buds for it or something like that?
I don't remember a logo.
Techno Temple.
The worst kept secret in the world is their blood mages.
Well, they were in Dunkelzahn's will, so yeah.
No one reads that thing. Yeah.
Never order it with the Pico. You don't know what's in the Pico.
It's just sauce.
All right, so we'll just hang out at a nearby restaurant, I guess, just where we parked. So we'll duck into the Taco Temple while we're hanging out, and let our tech guys do their tech stuff with trying to track down Brass Tiger a little more, and take it from there.
Tooth's going to hang out front and just kind of watch general comings and goings.
All right. Tooth, you're loitering.
Exactly.
Good to know for when Knight Errant comes by.
Why would they stop a clearly law-abiding young troll?
Why?
I imagine they have
especially with explosions down the street.
Oh, that was 10 minutes ago. It's over with.
How many combat rounds is that?
All right. You guys are chilling out at the Taco Bell, and
looks like Ness
is rolling tons and tons of hits.
So, 6 hits to try to find more on Brass Tiger's whereabouts, I believe it was.
All right, you start tracking down, and yeah, he's got a number of, like, Horizon Yelp whatevers comments up and down the strip. Looks like the last one that he posted was actually for the Taco Temple here about a week ago. He was praising Taco Temple's extra spicy pico sauce.
Oh, that's terrifying.
Have we got a pet, like any place that he's posted to multiple times?
Yeah, you find the equivalent of Foursquare. And he is he's the mayor of Taco Temple.
Throw down. That's issue a challenge on that thing.
Maybe we just hang out here.
So yeah, it looks like he visits here quite a bit.
Alright.
So you guys just want to chill out here then, or?
Well, I'm full on rib from the last place we were at, so yeah.
We could ask the staff. I mean, again, it would kind of be tipping our hand, but they might, you know, they're teenagers. They might know something.
Yeah. I mean, the worst that can happen is that they're friends with Tiger, and they let Tiger know people are looking for him, and then Tiger comes down here, and we have a talk.
Or Smith Town.
We only have a couple people in the restaurant instead of a big group of burly, mean-looking people.
That's why I stayed outside.
I gotta stay in the car.
He is a bland, charismatic troll wearing a nice suit.
That's why we
used to
blandness
too.
Yes.
Bland troll.
Yes. Yeah.
He said, "I spent money and essence on dental replacement surgeries."
Yeah, well, there you go.
He's had work done to be corporate smoothified. Yeah, I don't know. Dash, go hit up a server.
All right, I will go. Do we have a suitable person who looks friendly and gregarious who likes to talk? I will strike up a conversation with them.
It's fairly late at night, so there's, you know, only like a couple of people up in the front working the registers. Because, you know, they're not expecting tons of business this late at night. You know, another couple hours, they might get the bar rush, but... yes, there is a young girl. She looks like she's maybe 16, 17...
Grab her.
Entry level job.
All right.
No, it is definitely not her, since this young lady is African American and looks nothing like the photo you have.
Just on the outside chance. Hold the photo up to her face.
You are slick there, Quicker. Yeah.
Well done. She looks at you a little nervously, and can I?
I will kind of shoo Quick Root away and strike up a conversation with her and steer it towards the gang and then Brass Tiger in particular. And is there any particular skill you'd like to have me roll here?
Etiquette
to try and fit in and not be quite as
what's your suave roll?
My suave roll.
Etiquette's fine.
Etiquette. All right. Etiquette roll here. All right.
Got to rename that. I have an etiquette that specializes in suave.
I got, looks like 4 hits here.
All right. Okay. What are you saying? What are you attempting to do?
All right. We know that... he is the mayor of Taco Temple here. He posts a lot, right?
What's that?
We know that he is the mayor of Taco Temple, right?
Yes.
He posts a lot of things, comments.
Yes. Sure.
All right, so I'm going to try and go with that angle as in...
how do we bring this?
Looking for him and heard that he hangs out here a lot and...
You're challenging his mayoralship.
That'll bring him.
All right. Sorry, Tony. What were you saying?
I'm questioning the fact that, you know, he posts a lot here, and does he even show up here, or is he one of these guys that just posts reviews and, you know? It's a corporate fake, stooge of some kind, possibly.
He's a fake mayor. Temple girl.
That's right.
He's a poser mayor.
Exactly. He's a...
Oh, well.
She doesn't even know what's in the combo.
She looks a little confused.
I'm terrified.
You got one guy...
I smile.
Because you're a psychopath.
Well, you had one guy that comes up and holds a picture up next to her and goes, is this her? And then this guy's coming in going, who's this guy? He's the mayor, and I don't like him. I'm going to take over.
I was much more suave than that.
Okay.
It was a pretty suave role.
Yes, I'm...
Who's this guy? I'm going to take over. I don't know. I can't be smooth. I'm not suave at all, so don't ask me.
I can't either. That's why I was hoping the dice would work for me.
The dice will work for you. Yeah, you got to put a little effort in, but you know. All right. So, she's like, are you ordering something?
Yeah, I ordered the number one special. Hopefully it's still a burrito, because, you know, Quick Root needs that. Not that I mentioned that to her, but yeah, he wants a burrito, so I'll find the special that has a burrito just for Quick Root.
All right. That would be the number two combo.
I get the number two.
That is the super stuffed extra spicy burrito.
Perfect.
With queso sauce.
Oh, queso. So. They use extra ritual magic in that. Oh!
All right. It's like a volcano in your mouth. All right.
She sounds more like a dare than anything.
Well, most Taco Bell food is kind of like a dare. And I say this as somebody that eats a Taco Bell far too often.
Same.
All right. She's like, I... Are you showing him the picture?
Sure.
All right. She's like, I don't know, I guess. Customers come in. I don't really pay too much attention to them. I think I've seen them around here before.
It's obvious that she doesn't really know much. She's not hiding anything. Should I make a judge intentions roll or something
sure,
like that?
Sure, make a judge intentions roll.
I was just hoping he was saying that out loud. You don't know anything.
Quick, someone
you know nothing,
God. Well, that would be Quick Root if he was doing the new yeah. the talking.
All right, we have six successes on the judge intentions.
Okay. You're fairly certain she is not lying or anything. She's...
All right. Then I will kind of let it go, then. Yeah. I will get my order and bring Quick Root his extra spicy burrito with the queso and et cetera.
Okay.
All right, I'll be a Shadim by lunch.
Well, you mentioned something earlier about Knight Errant. What kind of security rating is this part of town?
This is a decent part of downtown. It is a, God, I don't remember the all the ratings. I want to say it's a B, probably a B or maybe even a single A.
Oh, okay.
It's not a, like I said, this is not a terrible neighborhood.
Okay.
Probably a C or a B, probably not a single A. That's more reserved for corporate areas.
So it's kind of at that generic real life.
Yes.
Suburban neighborhood sort
yeah,
of.
Yeah, like I said, it's apartment buildings and little restaurants and shops.
Right.
So don't pack the grenades, is what you're saying.
Well, you never know.
That's what pockets are for.
I do have a lot of pockets.
Especially troll sized pockets. You can hit a lot of grenades in those.
You're probably not going to be running around like a G.I. Joe character with, like, grenades strapped to your chest. But, yeah.
I do have bandoliers for them, but I don't
know. Oh, okay.
As a standard course of action.
All right, yes, you probably don't want to just in general, though, because, you know, that will probably get the,
No, I don't carry him around. I surely wouldn't bring him to a meet.
Or to, you know, a taco temple.
Right.
All right, So, all right, Dash and Quick Root were the two that were kind of up at the counter. Quick Root, make me a perception test.
Oh, boy. That's three whole dice.
Woo!
Seriously?
The burrito's made of people.
You know what? I'm going to edge that sucker.
Thanks for making me feel better about my perception.
Yeah, I felt bad with my 10 dice. I'm like, this is perception.
No, 10 dice, that's an average of more than 3. That's decent. That's, you know... Hey, I can actually see things that are uncommon to see.
The troll ganger rolls 4 dice, just FYI.
My perception roll is triple yours. not counting cyber eyes and cyber ears. Like, I'm just...
All right, what'd you get?
Ended up with.
What'd you get, Dan? You got 29?
Well, that's a sum. I got 3 successes.
But you said you used edge, right?
Well, I put the exclamation point in there, and that makes 6s explode. So
it already
I
had
4 edge. Okay. Yeah. Me 7 dice, 6s explode. So I got 4. I got 1 extra die.
Okay.
All right. So you got 3 hits. Okay. You notice that while Dash was talking, it looked like one of the guys in the back, one of the cooks, was paying a little bit of attention to you guys. And he kind of scurries off after Dash gets done talking.
The plan has worked.
The eagle has left the roost.
All right, a few minutes later, you guys kind of... Dash takes his burrito, gives it over to Quick Root. Does anybody else want to eat while you're here?
Mike is just kind of taking it easy and watching the entrances.
All right. So Quick Root's the only one that's going to be making a test later on. Good to know.
Is there any... Tooth will do while he's outside, kind of... is there any mark... Are there any, like, gang tags on the building itself?
Not really that you see. There's a little bit of graffiti, but nothing that stands out specifically as, like, a tag or anything like that.
Okay.
I love that these guys are such a small-time gang. None of us know what to look for. Like for their symbol, we're like, you know, whatever. Maybe it's dollar signs or something.
That kind of anonymity is the one that you were granted by being bland.
I mean, I assume they've stolen all the street signs that say Mercer Street.
Yeah.
They probably stole those for their clubhouse.
Actually, well, if they did, it looks like they got replaced, because you've seen plenty of Mercer Street signs.
Oh, okay.
That's their initiation, is stealing a street sign.
The guys outside in the car, did we see the cook come out the back, or did anyone tell us, or?
I don't know. Quick Root, did you tell them?
Dash or Root, did you guys tell the team?
I was too busy trying to figure out what I was going to do next with the burrito. What did I actually see with that perception? I'm sorry.
You saw, it just looked like one of the cooks was kind of listening to what you guys were talking about.
Oh, yeah, no.
And then he just looked slightly suspicious as he kind of, like, turned away and kind of scurried into, like, looks like he went to a back room or something.
I would immediately, as soon as I saw that, I would immediately, you know, surreptitiously link, cook's up to something.
You'd immediately turn around and go, hey, I think the cook is doing something. Out loud.
Type.
How does this sub-vocal mic work again?
I don't have any sub-vocal mics.
I know, that's the joke.
I'll be broke.
All right. You, yes. So you let everybody know. So yes, the guys outside know. You don't see anybody come out, though. About 15 minutes later, however, a truck rolls up, and 4 dudes get out. These guys are wearing, they're all wearing, it looks like they're wearing army fatigues with a black armor jacket over top of it.
I assume Tooth sees this happening.
Yes, Tooth and who else was out there? Chris.
Yeah, and I was here as well.
Oh, okay. So
Ness is still
Okay.
Yeah.
You guys see this?
Take a quick snapshot with my comm link of the guys.
Hey, Mikey, it looks like they showed up.
We'd like to make your perception. See what I can get on them.
Hey, Dash, you going to talk to these guys?
I am going to talk to them and see where it goes.
I will leave behind you.
Well, hold on, real quick. Who said something? They were doing something perception?
Matrix perception? I want to just grab what icons I can over there.
Looks like they just have comm links.
Just comm links?
Yep.
Okay.
That's all you see.
Do they appear armed?
Can I look for stealth?
What's that?
Stealth items?
Make a matrix perception, whatever that is.
Computer intuition versus logic sleep.
Yeah. And
well, this piece will just be.
What grid are you on? I probably should have asked about that.
Not the public grid, but the
Emerald City.
The Emerald City grid. It's bought through my one of my identities.
Okay. Yeah. Part of your lifestyle. Okay. Just go ahead and make a perception test.
All right. It's like 5 successes.
All right. What were you trying to do again?
Determine if they have any stealth devices.
All right.
Hidden icons, that kind of thing.
No. Doesn't look like they have anything stealthed.
Okay.
Tooth, make a visual perception test.
Yeah, I got 1 success.
Okay.
Can I do with Simon?
Yes. Are you out? Yeah, you're out there too.
Yeah, I'm outside. Three successes.
All right. Chris.
Mm-hmm.
You're fairly certain one of them, at least one of them, has a gun of some sort. Tucked into their... like a shoulder holster type.
So they don't have any guns big enough that Tooth saw him with 1 success.
No.
Right? No, he's not concerned. Okay, we're fine.
If it's not an obvious weapon, I don't care.
Right.
Sub-vocal mic, relay that to the team. One of them's armed.
All right.
What I'm fully expecting to happen here is we're going to start to talk, and it's going to just hit the fan, and, well, I'm the distraction here.
It's going to hit the fan, and we're going to be at a cliffhanger, so...
Yeah, I wanted to get a little further than this tonight, but, like I said, I'm still getting used to the whole bigger group thing, and we kind of went off the rails a couple times, so I apologize about that. All right, you guys meet up, or the four of them come walking into the Taco Hut, Taco Temple.
I hold the door for them.
What's that?
I hold the door for them.
They look at you.
Well played.
They look at you, and they're like, thanks, man.
And then I follow them in. Yeah.
All right.
Well, this will be fun.
They come in.
I'm enjoying my burrito.
Wait a half an hour. It's going to burn coming out.
Only half an hour?
Well, it is Mexican food. Well, it is pseudo-Mexican food.
Yeah, it's Mexican. It's Tex-Mex.
Actually, it's Aztec-Mex.
Yes. There you go. Even better.
Aztec-Mex.
Blood Mage-Mex.
It is a suspicious red color.
Yeah, I thought Pico's supposed to be green, but whatever.
Yeah, for some reason it's called Pico de Sangre.
Oh.
Alright, so, they come walking in, and, They look to the counter area, and Quick Root, are you paying attention to this at all?
Oh yeah.
Or are you actually being oblivious, eating your burrito?
No, I'm actually paying attention.
Okay. You can see they look over, and you can see the cook that you noticed earlier, kind of points over to you and Dash.
Oh bloody hell!
And the four of them promptly walk over to you. Mikey, okay. I'm assuming you're sitting with them or nearby.
Yeah, I was having a chat with Dash about how I'm going to loom behind him.
Okay.
While he talks.
And I'm so, going to move in from outside as well. Tooth does.
So okay. as they make a beeline for our table, I'm just going to stand up.
That's fine.
I'm going to say sitting down to try and, you know.
I'm gonna smooth
the situation.
Yeah.
But as they like come around, I'm gonna try to get as much of the sauce and everything else around my face as possible.
Food fight, oh god.
And then when they come into view, I'll just kind of look up at them surprised.
Alright. You look like a 12-year-old. You look like a 5-year-old that's covered in food and surprised. Alright. They kind of just the lead one kind of just shakes his head.
Is there only the one entrance?
No, there's a couple. There's two entrances out either side. It's your standard fast food joint layout. So there's one door on either side, coming in from either side of the counter, and there's probably a door going out the back.
Right. Okay.
So, and then there's, like I said, there's the table area, which is where you guys are at.
Do any of these four look like the picture we have of Brass Tiger?
No, they do not.
All right.
There are, like I said, there are four of them. One of them's an orc. Two of them are human, or three, and the other three are human, but one of them is a female, and the other three are male. All four of them appear to be like a Hispanic or Hispanic American, Hispanic Caucasian mix.
The orc is not the female.
The orc is not the female.
All right.
The orc seems to be the one that's kind of in charge because he's the one that's taking the lead. Yeah. He walks over to Dash.
All right.
Just walks right up to him. Kind of looks at the troll a little, you know, like, okay, yeah.
Nobody mentioned you. That's...
Looks down at Dash and it's like, so, what can I help you with?
I will look at him in the eye and look over at his three cohorts and say, Brass Tiger, where is he?
That's a good question. I'd like to know that myself. Known the boy for 14 years, been one of my best friends. About a week ago, he just up and quits. Don't know what happened. He's got himself a new squeeze, and all of a sudden he thinks he's a big shot. Says he's got some new guys he's going to run with. I don't know.
New squeeze?
Yeah, some girl.
Auburn hair, green eyes?
Yeah, sounds like her, some rich girl. He brought her around a couple of times. She was kind of... She seemed kind of snotty.
And you haven't seen either one of them for more than a week now?
Yeah, give or take.
So you in charge of the gang now?
I always was in charge. But Tiger was my bro, man. He was my second. And he's like, and you know, he kind of looks at you guys and goes, you know, I'll be honest with you guys, because you guys look like you're kind of... Well, most of you. He looks kind of down at Quick Root. He says, you guys are obviously know what you're doing, so... You know, this whole, you know... We're just local guys. We just kind of keep an eye on the neighborhood, that's it. Not really anything big.
Anything to do with those explosions earlier tonight?
Ah, shit. No, but I know what you're talking... Well, I don't know which ones you're talking about, but there's been a few. Now,
tonight or earlier?
Yes. Fuck, man, the damn, all the gangs are losing their mind. I don't know what's going on. This is fucking, apparently the Cutters and the Ancients are throwing down. And they're trying to drag all the littler gangs into it. Everybody's choosing sides, and I don't even know what's going on. That's apparently what Cutter got involved in. I'm actually a little worried about him.
Brass Tiger, you mean, not Cutter?
Yes. Cutter's than one of the gangs, sorry.
Yeah. Just clarifying.
So,
yes, Tiger.
So he's hooked up with the Cutters or the Agents, is what you're getting at.
Might be. I don't know. Like I said, he suddenly seemed... For years, I mean, this was just, you know, this was for fun. We were, you know, we played it being... Frankly, we played it being a gang, and it was kind of cool, and, you know, we kind of just kept an eye on the neighborhood. Kept other gangs from coming in here and causing problems and stuff. And that was fine for forever. We've been, like I said, since we were kids, this is one of the things we talked about. We took it over my, you know, Tiger's older brother started the gang 15, 20 years ago. And it was just, you know, it was just a thing. So now suddenly, it's not good enough for Tiger. Now Tiger wants to be a real guy. He wants to get in with the big guys. I don't even know. I think the girl's messing with his head.
Well... They'll do that.
He's like, it's like bitches, man. And then the girl behind him slaps him in the back of the head. Not you, Tina. Others.
So
you're one of the good ones.
When was the last time you saw Brass Tiger?
A week ago. He came up. He said, "I'm quitting." He says he made some new friends. And he said he was moving on to bigger and better things. He said it was like. Apparently, he said there was a lot of money involved.
Did he say where he was going beyond the possibly joining up with the gangs?
No, but he was talking about a dude named, what was it? Rust something. Rust Machete? Rust Machete was the dude's name. I don't know.
Rusty Stiletto?
No, that's another street gang.
I know, that's why I was...
No,
well,
Rust...
Wait, Rust you got Brass Tiger's contact info? Number?
I do, but he's not answering. I've tried calling him a few times. He's
We may be more capable than what you may be able to do here.
We got filth, I say as I spit some of the burrito out.
It's like somebody's idiot little brother that's just hanging out with us.
I fight the urge to pat him on the head, like, you know.
And it was the funny part. He's probably our best deep cover guy at the moment because he can surprise anyone.
He's surprising me every time he talks.
Hey.
Yeah. Yeah, he's like, you know what? Yeah. On one condition. Says, I'm assuming you guys... why are you guys looking for him, first off?
Before the squeeze. Oh, sorry.
Wait. We're looking.
I just gave up our negotiating position. I apologize.
We don't want to hurt him, if that's what you're worried about.
Well, that's what I'm worried about. I'm just wondering why you're looking for him. Did he do something to you guys, or, you know?
We're not looking for him.
You're looking for the girl.
Yes.
All right. That's fine with me. If you can send her packing and get him home, that's even better. So, all right, here. You guys promise you're not going to hurt my boy? Because if you do, let's face it, there's not much we can do about it. Like, but, you know.
If you do, I'll be all right. Sad.
He's like, you know, I'm not going to front with you guys, you know. Like I said, especially you. You scare me.
Well, with both trolls looming over here.
He's pointing at the two of them.
You know, I don't even want to hit him. It's kind of sad.
He knows better. They're just, you know, yeah, you get the impression that these guys are really, they're gang posers more than anything. You know, you figure they probably just kind of kept the neighborhood, you know, from getting overrun with the other gangs or whatever, and that was about it. You know, kind of what some of the little tiny street gangs used to be.
That's fair.
Yeah, they're basically just trying to protect their own family and friends.
I mean, they're
Well, and they play it up like they're big shots in the neighborhood.
Well, because they have to. Yeah.
Well, it's kind of fun. Yeah, right up until a bunch of...
they all get murdered.
Yeah, until a bunch of Shadowrunners roll in and make them look like punks.
Or anybody with an actual gang entry in a book.
Well, yeah.
Like, any of them.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Fortunately, Mercer Street is not exactly, you know, prime, you know, territory.
Cares.
Yeah.
We're the princes of no one gives a fuck.
Well, you know, there is the Valley Street Jackals a couple streets over, but that's about it.
They're princes of bum fuck Egypt. Right?
Well, you know, they throw down, they dance fight occasionally.
Capoeira.
No, they're doing the Sharks and the Jets thing.
There you go.
And didn't someone mention Macbeth in the chat earlier?
So
wrong Shakespeare.
Yeah. All right. Oh my god.
I will reassure that our intention is not to hurt Brass Tiger.
Yeah, he gives you the phone number. Or he gives you his comlink number.
I do take a moment to wipe off my face once we've had this, and I say, you mentioned money?
No.
You heard about a big score. Like, that was the whole deal that
that. No, he's joining a gang for the money.
Oh. Well.
He was, because, you know, because we don't extort the local neighborhood or stuff. So we just, like I said, we're not exactly, like, making money. We're not selling drugs to the kids. We're not, you know, extorting the local businesses.
Terrible gang.
they really
I
are.
I know.
Yeah. Tooth is ready to give him a card and say, if you guys get really into trouble, give me a call. I'm going to help you out.
Yeah.
Does Tiger have a an apartment or a place he hangs out here or used to hang out here?
Yeah.
There might be some info there that we might be able to use.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, he gives you an address. It's right down the road. It's on Mercer Street here. There's an apartment building. He's like, apartment 3A.
Couldn't join the Mercer Street gang if you didn't live on Mercer Street.
Yeah, I mean, that's their one rule.
Gotta pull your left eye if you're going to be part of the left eye gang.
why don't we offer, see if he'll help us talk to him. Talk some sense into him.
If you can get a hold of him, sure. No problem. I'm going to do some basic recon just to get the logos and base levels of information. Okay. That is not a problem. Look in the Street Samurai or the Seattle source.
Yeah, I know. I just want to make sure that I'm doing it so I'm not caught flat-footed.
Nope, that's fine. There's plenty of public information about those two gangs.
Yes, I know.
They are two of the largest gangs in Seattle, after all.
I'll ask this guy if he's got contact info. If we find any information out, we'll let him know.
Sure. Yeah, he can give you his number.
What's his name?
His name is...
Can he give it to us?
Yeah, he gives it to you. His name is,
Senior Wences.
No. It's,
James Mercer.
James Mercer. There you go. It's gotta go with the James theme.
James.
His brother found
the name's Mercer. James Mercer.
Exactly.
No, he is, he calls himself Silver Lion. They have a whole theme. He introduces the rest of his gang, and it's like,
oh, no.
The girl's name is she's Gold Cheetah, and yeah, they seem to have his name. Yeah, kinda.
You guys are adorable.
I know.
The one human's completely unoriginal calls himself Panther Cannon.
he's under. Yeah, you mock him until he pulls out the panther.
No, I want that to be Tooth's street name for his honorary membership in Mercer Street
Panther
Mercenaries. Panther Cannon.
There you go.
But even
call me in.
That's after the burritos had some time.
Oh, no.
Exactly.
Oh, God.
Oh,
you,
good Lord.
Got the glass cannon at that point.
Yeah.
All right.
Tony, we got to hit Taco Bell tomorrow.
So he gives you the address. He gives you his contact info. He says, let me know, what I can do for you. If you guys can bring my buddy back, I'd appreciate it. No. And hey, anytime you guys are down this way, you're welcome. This is, our street's your street.
Step away from being honorary members here, guys.
Thinking this would be a good place for a safe house, so I'm making a note.
It totally could be anytime we wanted it. Yes.
Are you actually saying that?
No, I'm just like,
well, yeah.
Like, that's like.
Damn, dude, little alpha there.
I will give the impression that we feel grateful that this offer that they made to us, as opposed to what, what we're really thinking
that's
here.
That's a con roll right there.
Well, you didn't just roll in and start beating the shit out of everybody, so they assumed you're halfway decent people. They assumed wrong, but still.
No, we're not doing anything to anybody.
I only got 3 hits on that con roll there, so.
All right, you're fine, though.
They believe it.
He buys it hook, line, and sinker.
I mean, it does seem like a safe little neighborhood.
Until we got here, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying, it's...
Explosions aren't going off here.
The property dropped that $20,000 when we got here.
Yeah.
I feel like setting up an ice cream shop.
You mean an ice cream truck?
You gotta have a shop, then you can have the truck.
There you go.
Alright. You guys want to go check out his apartment then?
Yes.
Yep.
Alright.
And I think our Decker friends should see what they can find out on that his phone number and all that stuff, if there's any.
Sure. Is there any way to track down the device location or see what I can find on the phone number itself? Or
That is a good question. And I'm going to say sure.
All right.
All right. First thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need to find the icon. So you're going to do, you're going to need to do a let's call it a matrix search test. So computer plus intuition with your limit as data processing.
And it looks like Quick Roots trying to assist me, and is that accurate? I've never
Yes.
done the assist
before. Yeah, that's all.
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yep, that's an assist test, and he can do that. All right, so you got 5 hits?
Multitask. Yes.
All right. Okay, it's going to take a little time, but you can do it. Are you guys still hanging out here at the Taco Temple?
No, I think we're heading to his apartment.
Okay. You guys will reach the apartment well before you're done doing this. So,
okay.
We'll kind of do this as a sideline thing, and then we'll come back and see what the rest of them are doing, and we'll kind of just assume it's happening simultaneously.
Do you want to just, we could just like say that we leave them in the car?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can stay with them, keep an eye on them, just make sure nothing happens.
You never know.
Stay on your side, Ness.
The Mercer Street's teddy bears may come back for him.
That's right. Yeah. Something.
The Care Bear crew.
All right. The next thing you're going to need to do is a trace icon test. You need to get 2 marks on the system first, though. So.
All right.
Do you want
I'm
going to
use Hack on the Fly.
Okay.
You have baby monitor, right, Ness?
I do not have baby monitor, but I have a lot of stuff to help me in case things go south.
Just do it fast. You don't need baby monitor.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's a my hacker's role. Not wasting a fucking program slot on that. Let's just do this. And just, if you're good enough, if you're good enough, you don't need to worry about it.
Logic, limit sleaze, and then versus intuition and firewall.
Right. Trace icon requires 2 marks. So you'll either need to make 2 hacks, or you can take a minus. Yeah, you can take a -4 dice pool to try to get 2 at once.
Or you could go for all 3 if you're not a chicken.
What's the matter, McFly? Chicken?
Hey, that's how
literally unconscious in the back of your car.
So I can do it with -6 on my pool.
I'm just saying, that's how I got a T-Bird. You guys think I'm joking, but he had
I remember. I heard all about
the Panzer in one action.
I'm going to take 2 actions, make sure I do this properly.
All right. Okay, first one.
All right, first one. Sure, there we go. I think I did it.
Damn! What's your sleaze?
My sleaze limits my logic. And it's limited to
sleaze is the limit for a hack on the fly test.
Yeah. So sleaze modified by any programs you have that might modify.
My sleaze is effectively an 8 for this.
Okay.
Nice.
All right, so you got 8 hits then.
Yeah. I didn't feel comfortable taking a 4 dice full
penalty
on that.
Hey, if you're going to do something, do it right.
All right. Well,
And slow.
Right.
Low and slow. All right. You got a matrix. You got a mark on it.
And actually, to be fair, since you're doing this hot sim, I'm assuming, right, Ness?
Cold sim.
Okay. So it's taking him, like, a round.
All
of 3 seconds.
But we've gone 5 feet.
Yeah. Well, the search was what took a while because basically had to fire up the programs and they had to go. They did a big grid scan and everything, and that took a little while.
All right, I'm going to drop the second mark.
All right.
Ooh.
All right, 3 hits. You get a second mark.
Sweet. All right, then I'll run the find icon.
I'm putting pieces of burrito into Ness's mouth. While he's doing this,
feeding him like a baby bird.
He's gone. He doesn't know crap right now.
Exactly. All right. Okay. Roll your trace.
All right. Trace icon.
This is computer plus intuition, and it's data processing is your limit on this one.
Hey, do you come towards your god score?
Is data processing 5. So I did not hit my limit, but that's 4 successes.
Okay, you find the location. He is in Tacoma, down south a little ways.
Okay.
Shit.
I'd like to do one more thing.
Yeah, you
and
can.
Then
you
I
actually get an ad.
That count reboot.
You can actually like match up where you find it to Google Maps or whatever, and actually get a location. All right. What else? What else is going on?
I'm going to switch out. Where is it? I'm going to switch out my shell program for Bootstrap, and then going to go for one more mark on him, so I can do a reboot device and have it ping every once in a while with his location after I log out. It just pings the matrix with his location, so I can easily find it.
Okay.
All
Is this Comlink you're doing this to?
Yes. All right, so I need a third mark.
Yep.
Do that one first. Just like I got 4 successes.
All right, you got a third mark.
And then this is reboot devices, computer plus logic, data processing versus willpower firewall. And another 4 successes for the reboot device with the changes added in.
Okay. You complete that.
And then I'm going to reboot my own device.
Okay, so you guys are doing that. The rest of you guys head up to the apartment. That was Ness and Tooth.
Yep.
Tooth, just for shits and giggles, give me a perception test.
Can do.
I love the deflection. Just for shits and giggles, not because you might see something.
I got one.
All right. Well, there is
You saw nothing.
No, you see a Lone Star patrol car cruise down the street.
K.E. patrol car.
It goes right by you, but
Lone Star?
Okay, sorry.
Knight Errant.
All right. I was a little nervous there.
Yeah,
I was
a little nervous.
Lone Star is still around Seattle.
Yeah.
They're just down to private security now.
Right? Did they do the slow roll fast?
No.
Or are they just at a normal speed?
They just drive right by at normal speed.
Okay.
Then they see that you're a troll and they slow down.
Right.
No. You're good.
Okay.
All right, you guys go up to the apartment. It's a little bit of an older apartment. It's not terrible. It's not a high expensive place. They do have the front door, the main lobby front area is not locked. So you can walk right into the apartment building. And it does appear that the apartments themselves have a maglock. Type system. So, how you getting in?
We have 2 trolls.
Okay. Were you going to try to get in a way that doesn't involve loud noises and possible neighbors calling cops?
Can we be a little more subtle? It has to be a way, maybe. My character doesn't know. I have no skills for that, but I assume there's people can do that sort of thing.
Yes.
There's locksmith and hardware and stuff like that can do it.
Yeah, I mean, I got hardware.
Well, if you don't have it, but you have locksmith, you can attempt to do it.
Yeah, I mean, if it comes down to it, yes, a door can be kicked in.
And these do not look like heavy security doors of any kind.
So nobody on the team has locksmith?
No, best I've got is hardware.
It's an agility test, so you can always default.
Is there another entrance to this place? Like, is there a window or something?
Well, yes, but it is on the 3rd floor.
Fire escape or anything?
No, there's no fire escape. It's not that fancy.
I didn't realize those were fancy.
The residents just get to burn to death, you know.
Hey, as someone who lives on the 3rd floor of an apartment without a fire exit, you're damn right.
Yeah, I've lived in an apartment that had on the 3rd floor that had no, yeah.
Real quick, none of this conversation happened over comms, right?
Yeah, my assumption is this is us.
So there's no reason that Tooth would mention that Knight Errant just rolled past.
So, but nobody has the tools or anything. Like nobody has.
Well, we'd ask, does anyone have a way to? We'd involve you guys with anyone got a way to get in a maglock? I'm assuming that Ness is kind of out of it right now, so it'd be up to you, Tooth. I'm assuming you don't have one.
I do not.
And I don't have the lock.
By the way, Knight Errant just rolled past. Looks like a routine patrol, but they are in the area before you make any noise.
All right, so nobody has the tools we need to try and pick the lock, and nobody has pass keys or anything like that.
Nope.
Because there's additional penalties for trying to do this sort of thing without the tools.
Yeah, you need an electronic kit. Yeah,
well, did anybody try the door?
I'll do it.
The door is locked.
I'll knock.
Yeah, might as well knock.
And then, like, he'll be idly pulling up on his comlink, looking for like a pawn shop nearby, because those are the best places to go buy auto pickers. And he's got the money to buy an auto picker. So if it comes down to, you know, making a quick purchase,
it's actually not an auto picker you need.
No,
you want a maglock passkey.
Yeah.
Just depends on the type of the line.
Well, in this case, it is specifically it's a scan lock, not
okay.
A...
Okay, so it would be a passkey.
It would be a passkey.
Still probably going to be a pawn shop is the best local place to take a look. But yeah, if it comes down to it, I might bust out a contact or something. So he'll just knock on the door. We'll see what happens.
There's no answer.
Might be somebody home.
You wait for a few minutes, and there's no answer.
All right. I'm going to try and get a hold of one of my contacts then. So I'll just text the team. Like, you guys want me to just kick it? If not, I could try to get a hold of a passkey.
But and was there a response when Mikey knocked on the door?
No.
No. He said, you know. So I figure we're having this conversation quietly while after knocking, waiting, you know, that sort of thing.
I mean, if you do, I can keep watch out here and let you know if anyone pulls up.
All right. Okay, I'm going to ring up my contact. He has a former corporate security hacker that I feel like might be able to get a hold of a maglock passkey for me.
All right. What's his contact rating?
It's connection 3. So that's.
Don't we have this guy's comlink?
No.
Well, we're still working on hunting it down. We haven't heard back from Ness yet on
how successful
we are on finding stuff.
Okay.
But it seems like the sort of contact, you know, it's the guy that used to be the on-site tech support for his company man days.
Okay. Is he no longer? Is he an ex-company man like you?
Yeah, he's a Shadowrunner now.
Okay.
So he figured it was worth a shot.
All right.
He will call up his now freelance Decker friend and see if he can give him the hookup.
All right.
We want to call this like a charisma plus connection rating, I guess, or something like that.
Yeah, sounds
good. I don't remember the general rule. But yeah, I mean, he's got the money and stuff. He's just going to try and see. So there's a charisma plus connection rating roll that I defaulted to.
All right.
It'll make it clear that we've got, you know, we got the money for one. Just want to know if you might have one for sale or know somebody somewhere near Mercer Street in downtown that might have a shop or something.
All right. Yeah. He tells you, does he have a name?
Dane.
Dang? Dane?
D-A-N-E.
D-A-N-E, Dane.
As in, like, person from Dane, you know, from Denmark.
Okay.
It's his nickname.
All right. He's like, yeah. He's like, what kind of rating were you looking for?
Highest as possible.
I mean, they go to 4, so he'll check with the team how much we want to spend on this.
Whatever
team funds, or you guys want me to hold on to it? I'll just say the best. You know, the best you can get me.
All
right. I just remembered how much he's getting paid for this. So Mikey's like, "Fuck, never mind. He'll buy it. He'll hold on to it."
He can get you
so,
ready
he'll just go. Perfect. Where can I meet you for the handoff? Right. Or, you know, where he's going to sell it, whatever.
Did you actually ask him somewhere near Mercer Street?
Yeah. Like, or if you know a shop, you know, if you have a reliable black marketeer.
Well, there's a taco temp. No.
There you go. Now that my plausible deniability is gone.
You know, those guys might have a key to his apartment now that I think about it.
Yeah, we're good. We're Shadowrunners. We have to do this our own way.
He says he can meet you somewhere a few miles away.
Cool.
Not a problem to get a hold of it.
Sweet.
It's gonna take him a couple hours. So
okay.
You guys kind of pause everything for a couple hours to get a hold of the...
We just want to case out the place, see if they're going to come back. And then... So, to the team, I'll buy this back out of my cut once we get paid, but I'm going to need that upfront payment to cover this. It should only be about $8,000.
I will send over
$8,000.
All right. Cool? All right.
Okay. You get the maglock and get back. Not a problem.
Do they show up while we're waiting?
Nope.
All right then. It is still a good investment. Okay then. I will use my maglock passkey. All
right.
On the maglock.
I believe in this case it's just double the maglock versus double the
opposed test between the passkey rating and the maglock rating.
Okay, yeah, so roll double the... So roll 8 dice.
Sure.
Versus the maglock. Are you running the maglock wirelessly?
So 2 hits.
Are you running the... Because you get a plus 1 bonus to its rating if it's wireless.
Sure.
Because apparently it's looking up this particular model.
Didn't help, but... So 2 hits.
All right, well, that's better than the 0 hits I got.
Perfect. Money well spent.
All right.
There you go.
So the door.
I have a maglock passkey to add to mine.
The light turns green and the door opens. And that's when the dragon attacks.
Sweet.
No, okay. You dig around the apartment. We're just going to kind of, because we're after 12:30 now, so we're just going to kind of skip forward to the break point.
Some perception rolls in order, or what do you want us to do?
Don't worry about it. We're going to assume that you guys search the apartment long enough you can find anything that's in there. you guys dig around a little bit, and you find he has a... he's actually got a notepad that looks like he was writing some stuff down on. The notepad has the name... it's written in somebody else's handwriting. Or, it's written in very, like, flowing, flowery handwriting.
Very just say girly.
Well, yeah,
it's very neat, girly, legible handwriting.
Correct.
So Dash wrote this.
Yeah, so Dash wrote this.
I have a confession to make. I've been in this apartment before.
So you
calligraphy and the whole thing.
You are a brass tiger. Dun, dun, dun.
No, you find it
I am brass tiger.
Oh, we never knew. We find you. It's got the name of Rust Machete. And there's an address and there's a time listed. There's no date, but you assume that it was. Everything's got like just a slight bit of dust on it. Like nothing's been touched in here for like a week.
What's the address?
It's Tacoma address.
So I will, using my cyber eyes, do a quick snapshot of that. Text it to Ness. And go, hey, how's this jive up with where his comlink is?
Same general area.
Okay. Well, we have confirmation-ish of where to go next. Sound
we get
like...
to publish again.
There's some beer in the fridge if you want to raid his fridge. otherwise, it's just this little apartment, not a whole lot of furniture or a whole lot of anything else in here to speak of.
Ness, look for pay data.
From the number 2 of the Mercer Street mercenaries?
Yeah. You managed to snag his personal calendar, which has got all of the like birth dates of his relatives listed.
Damn.
So if you really...
$50 from his grandmother.
And if you really want, you can send them all birthday presents.
There you go.
So,
Hijacked the $5 million check from his grandma on his birthday.
Yeah. Exactly.
Horizon will pay good money for that information. They don't screw, have it yet.
Screw this Amelia chick. We don't need that job no more. We're good.
We are going to go. So we're going to go ahead and call it here. Because, like I said, it is getting a little
we
bit.
We say late. That we're piling into cars to go to Tacoma.
Yes.
And yeah. We drive away from the camera when the credits roll.
Yes.
Exactly.
That's what's going on. All right.
I just got to be continued down at the bottom.
We'll have action shots from the next scene when, like, I'll be eating a burrito and the trolls will be, like, throwing me bodily.
That's
and,
right. There's some like, jazzy music, you know.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Some sort of, you know.
Various buildings that Tooth is standing outside of.
Yes.
Tooth did a great job of standing outside and looking intimidating.
That's right.
All right, gentlemen, thank you for playing.
Indeed, was a blast. Thank you for running.
I'm going to toss this out since we didn't really get nearly as far as I wanted tonight. I mean, you guys didn't even get to shoot anybody. mainly because, A, you split the party. You did split the party, and you were smart enough to bypass the little Steppenwolf's fracas.
Yep.
So you didn't get embroiled in that. So you guys
can't not shoot us because we split the party. There's no fun in that.
Well, you guys were smart and decided to move away from the fight rather than going through the fight or checking it out.
We got shit to do.
Safety this way. Yeah.
You know, I know a lot of players that would be a big flag to let's go check it out.
Yeah, there are just some missions in play now where it's like. And then something happens, and
they expect you, yeah.
And, like, and the players are like, "No,
traffic was worse in that direction. I went the way where there was less traffic."
Exactly.
Mikey's thing is just fuck a bunch of knight errant. Is they fired me, so they can handle that shit now. I've got another job to do. So
right. Exactly. It is way better.
My question for everybody is: do you want to pick up next week, or do you want to wait till next month?
Next week's going to be rough for me. About the only thing.
Oh, next week's the 4th of July, isn't it?
Yeah. That's a non-starter.
We could bump it to the week after if you guys want.
See how that goes after.
All right, we'll talk about it on Facebook.
Yeah. I'm done.
So we'll plan
other
for.
I know people have stuff. Yeah.
We'll plan for as soon as possible, just because you know.
Yeah.
Don't want to leave it hanging too long.
No, indeed not.
And next week, hopefully, we'll be able to get a little more into it, because now that you've done all the legwork, you should be able to start getting into the meat a little more.
Yeah, less introduction time. Yeah.
And we may have a mage to counter that mind control crap that's coming our way.
I'm not a big fan of mind control. I'd rather just, you know, mana bolt everybody.
Yeah, that's what the person controlling your mind wants you to think, Paul.
Hey, nobody's controlling my mind except for... never mind.
Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for playing. Tune in next time for the ongoing adventures of our intrepid Shadowrunners.
No longer all elves. No longer all elves.
No longer, the all elf party. I'm a little disappointed.
Two trolls and a human and an orc human.
An orc human thing.
Yeah.
All right. Hope you guys had fun.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Nice meeting you.